All right, let's do a cheers to the Sober to Sick with Liquid Beer for the podcast.
Tonight to the North, we ride again.
I love you guys.
Careful, that cake's hot.
He did it at plus 730. He did it. Connor Brown having one go off his skate as he drove hard to the net. And he put one in the back of the goals. The Edmonton Oilers roll over the Washington Capitals. Good morning, everyone. A conch for Connor Brown today. Connor Brown to the thought of scoring goals now.
You're going to live with me now. I'm going to take care of you.
Oh, everybody loves him now. The ovation last night looked absolutely incredible.
On the seventh, and what a goal indeed. I mean, you're going to be telling grandkids. Marshall's going to be...
Oh, Marshall's telling his kids. So now he was in bed, but still.
Well, you know.
He's telling his kids exactly what happened.
He'll be watching the replay.
Last night at Rogers Place. Yeah. Nielsen's show. Coming at you from the Popeyes Louisiana Kitchen Studios this morning. If you're looking for a little treat today, why not hit up Popeyes, get that blackened chicken sandwich up in you. And, of course, Popeyes wings, absolutely delicious and also massive, almost as massive as the way the Oilers won that game last night.
I think you take today being it a Thursday prior to a Friday, which then leads into a weekend, and use today as somewhat of a Connor Brown day, shall we say.
Is that it?
Stuff you wouldn't normally do, treat yourself. Get the large at Popeyes.
Do it a little
extra today.
Are
yourself.
We officially labeling today as Connor Brown Day in the city of Edmonton?
I mean, I'll take an unofficial labeling at this point, but I think leading into a Friday, why not live a little loose today and in honor of Connor Brown, treat yourself.
Where is our mayor when we need him? you got to step up. Where's the key to that city, man?
Key to the city. Hyman can give it to Connor Brown.
All right, your Connor Brown text today. We got to have him. 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. That'll get you into the Paris Jewelers inbox this morning.
It's the ring box. It's the bling box. It's the Paris Jewelers inbox. And they got lots of fancy, shiny things.
Look at this, look at that.
Not just for the ladies. They got jewelry for men, too. The ring box, the bling box, the Paris Jewelers inbox.
It's like I'm surprised by the inbox at the end there, right? Like, it's the Paris Jewelers inbox.
Well, you didn't know what you had until you kind of got through the sentence. Yeah. You're like, it's Paris Jewelers inbox.
Yeah, then it really worked out. Yeah, so yeah. That was great. 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. And we'll get to more of your text messages as we work our way through the show. And, yeah, it's getting absolutely – well, Corey B., who was with us at Hudson's last night. Good time at Hudson's last night.
Great time.
My goodness. Yeah. Real good time at Hudson's last night. I was just looking at one of his texts last night. He said he was in the bathroom, I think, when Connor Brown scored. Yeah. that's exactly why you hold it, man. That's exactly why you hold it until Connor Brown scores.
Three plates of wings last night.
Who?
Me.
You?
Yeah.
You had three plates of wings. I saw you dumping off like the tail end of one of them to Maddie and the Godfather, who was there last night.
I had one Cajun wing and a half left of the dry rub. But all boneless, which was really rubbing Troy the wrong way. Pun intended.
That's why he was after me, because I got chicken tendies and a poutine last night. And he's like, you might as well just got the boneless wings.
Well, it was $5. You couldn't go wrong. Well, I mean, the deals there last night were, I mean, the draft, the wings, the whole bit, the 6 o'clocker lager. Didn't break me last night, but I left there quite full, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, much. No, it was a good time at Hudson's last night. Back there on Tuesday at West Edmonton Mall, and then Thursday, Saturday next week at the White Ave location. And the Saturday night game against Maple Leafs, full-blown EST watch party. So we'll have the crew out there. That should be a lot of fun.
Earlier in the day, it's Canada, Trinidad, Tobago on the pitch as well.
Here you guys are trying to pull a double.
And we want to do the Hudson's Bourbon. And then Maddie's already agreed to chauffeur. That's still on the table? Love it.
Oh, he's good. Okay.
From Bourbon Street to White for the watch party.
So you guys are going to go watch soccer at Bourbon Street, Hudson's, and then come down to the White Ave.
Pray for LTE.
Wow. That's
going to
be a day.
Yeah, let's get going.
That's going to be a day for you, buddy.
Oh, that's fine.
Oh, that's okay. No, don't worry. He'll walk. Don't worry. He'll walk. He'll get you there, but he's not taking you back home.
I'll take it.
I like it. You got to clarify that early when you're offering your buddies a ride.
Plans, man.
I'll get you there, but you got to find your own way home.
But start making plans today for that event.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, next Saturday, it's Oilers Leafs, 5 o'clock start. Come on,
get up
for that
one.
That's
going to
be a real
changing.
Good time. By then, Tommy would have been reset already. Like he'll be rolling.
Yeah, Jason Andre out last night as well. Out from Leduc.
The Wolf was in the house.
The Wolf, yeah.
Yeah, the Wolf's wife was there, and then he like sent her home and came back in. the Wolf was having a time last night. So he's got that AM Nasty jersey. Which is just the best.
Oh, he's just got that AM Nasty, I think.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure. Box Pounder's in. Could be text of the day today. For A&W, A&W's got the great deals all the time. The value deals kicking around. By the way, I was exchanging emails yesterday with our contact over at A&W. Mm. Spicy Piri Piri buddies. They're sticking around till April. It was a success. Because I replied. We were talking about like the deal that they've got coming up here starting next week and what they're rolling out. And I said, just so you know, like the reaction to the Piri Purity was awesome. And she goes, good. Tell your listeners it's sticking around until April.
Well, good.
So for those of you who've tried that Piri Purity and loved it, it's going to be around until April. So that's good news. But they always got these value deals. A&W Buddy Burger for just $2.79. A&W value deals. Always tasty. Never pricey.
Still time to make that three-patty stack.
Yeah, why not? I mean, are you living or what? Connor Brown is now only 925 goals away from catching Wayne Gretzky. What a time to be alive.
Well,
Box Pounder's in. I like it. Box Pounder, that's a strong way to start Texas today.
I think it's three games post-deadline. He's got a goal. That's a pretty good.
Yeah, like since the deadline.
Since the deadline.
This is that classic self-rental.
That's what we're saying here. Yeah.
Ken Holland's always up to his old tricks.
On the cheap.
Always up to his old tricks.
I don't need to acquire him. We already have him.
We have him. Saved him. Activate him. We were talking about today, they didn't want him to score because they needed a rallying point at this point of the season as they launched their way down the stretch, and that was it. Edmonton is an amazing market because this dude has just been, you know, torn apart by the fan base for 5 months and then scores and gets the biggest standing ovation we've seen here outside of the playoffs, and I don't even remember when.
I don't know what it means.
It was wild. Congratulations to Connor Brown, man.
Yeah.
Through the thick and thin of it. Now, I know many of you
may rest.
Many of you are only here today because you want that Connor Brown Off the Schneid song. And that's what it's called. It's called Off the Schneid. We're going to get to that. I got to lay out the show for you first. We'll get into your morning announcements. Not a busy night, but an important night, I think, in the National Hockey League last night with some of the results. So
yeah,
we'll get into that with the morning announcements coming up here a little bit later on for 100.3 The Bear. 6:30 today, your award-winning EM Utility Locating morning after show. We'll hear what Connor Brown had to say after scoring the goal. Luke Gazdic just after 7 o'clock today. Cool Bet hotline of the day. Can I take a second? Are you kidding me right now? The Lock Shop is on a bloody heater this week.
Can't be stopped.
EST Parlay, an absolute no sweater last night. Nuge point, Hyman point, McDavid 2+ points. Oilers win in reg. Never in doubt. I had people tweeting me in the second period being like, thanks for the parlay. And I was like, let's wait. Like, they got to win in reg. They were like, no, we're good. Like, don't worry about it. It's going to be fine. Cool Bet hotline of the day yesterday. Leon Draisaitl scoring a goal from his spot. That's exactly what we said.
He knocked the door down. Draisaitl finally went
from
down.
His spot was the Cool Bet hotline of the day yesterday. Cash that plus money. We literally said yesterday when we were making the Draisaitl pick that you might as well sprinkle Connor Brown at plus 730. Mm. I know many of you did. We hit that. Congratulations. The game day prediction was that the Connor Brown line would score. They did. The Lock Shop play of the day yesterday was a Nathan MacKinnon goal. He now has 9 in his last 8 games. But boom, nailed that. Like, it was just, we're on an all-time heater. Cool Bet hotline of the day is 3 for 3 this week. Lock Shop play of the day is 3 for 3 this week. And we've been banging out parlays every single day. Cool Bet is taking an absolute pounding. At some point, they're going to have to quit on us. Because it's been going too well. It's been going too well. Cool Bet hotline. I mean, you have your ups and downs. Stay cool, bet responsibly. You have your ups and downs. We're just on an upward trend right now, and it's been a nice week. 7:30 today. I got beef. We'll get to that for Acme Meats. Eat fresh, eat local, eat Acme. Keyword for Vegas. Stop asking about it. 7:45 today. Lock it in. Lock it in. 7:45 today. Keyword for that trip down to Vegas. 2 nonstop flights. 3 nights accommodations. Tickets to a Cirque show. And flexibility to book. That's what you really want with our partners down at FlyYG.
That's the key in that thing, yeah.
I've got kind of easy trivia for Mr. Mike's. We got 3 questions too many for Park Mazda. I says, pardon? We'll get into that around 8:30 today. And scalding hot takes today for Claiborne Services. If you're looking for work, you want to change in scenery, you want to make a ton of money really fast, Claiborne Services is hiring. They're looking for you. Visit them at claiborneservices.com. They're looking for bricklaying journeymen, apprentices of all levels. Great mentorship program. They'll take care of you. All right, we got the morning announcements coming up, but we've waited long enough. Now, what I do want to say is that I'm not sure any of this happens. It's like when we turned the Oilers season around in a game against Washington in which we cracked a 6 o'clocker lager for the first time.
That's right. And we mentioned yesterday the Washington Capitals games this season.
Yeah.
They've been occasions,
big.
Yeah.
They've been big. And I feel Connor Brown's season was turned around by the married couple. Right? The married couple, as I tweeted this morning.
They took him in.
The married couple walked so that Jonty and Victoria could run. When Connor Brown finally scored, if you're new to the show or you're listening on TuneIn or iHeart, quick reset. Married couple sent us this about 10 days ago, and we've been playing it. And turns out he was trying.
Browner, do you want to score a goal, man? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you shoot the puck. Out of luck, you should practice every day. You used to score like 20, and now you're not. I wish we could find out why. Do you want to score a goal, man? Does it need to be a hat trick?
I'm trying.
Tell me why.
So that got him. That got him going. That got him going. Last night, he got himself off the schneid, which is the name of the song that Jonty. So we've had a bunch of Jonty originals. We've got our first Jonty and Victoria parody, and it's called Off the Schneid. We think you're going to like it. Another banger from John T and Victoria. And this is worth the wait.
I can't
remember.
Wait.
We're like, should we play it? Then we got the, do you want to score a goal, man? We're like, well, we'll play that instead.
I haven't even listened to this off the, I know
this guy hasn't even heard it.
We talk, we do a show, we plan things, we talk things. I full surprise. First time.
Connor Brown, Off the Schneid song.
I think we're gonna be glad. I think it's today, yeah. Connor Brown scored last night. His dragon is slain. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about time. He's had chances galore, two and ones and breakaways, yeah. But he could never score, even strength of power play. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. Got to play McDavid line. You should have scored one, you should have scored twice by now. And got to play alongside Dry. How could he not score? How did he not score? How? He's played on every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah. He can never find the twine till he found his last game. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time.
Jaunty in Victoria with the Connor Brown Off of the Schneid song. Off of the Schneid.
Well,
it's
job.
About effing time.
Well, job.
Real nice stuff. Real nice stuff from Jaunty in Victoria. The legend has done it again. He has done it again. I feel like there's a Esty in the future of Jaunty in Victoria. Like, there just has to be. Our goal songs brought to you by our great partners. Over at Sportball, if you're not yet signed your kid up for Sportball, what are you even doing? Visit them at www.sportball.ca. They've got their regular programs, plus right now they're booking summer camps and finding something for your kid to do for like a week in the summer or something. Get it done with Sportball. It's actually sitting at the bar at Hudson's last night next to a guy who's helped on some training for Sportball.
Okay.
I was like, what? You know, yeah, like that bald guy who's sitting right next to me. He sits down and he's having some wings. I said, oh, no. He goes, hey, love the show. I was like, oh, thanks.
We called him Bizarro Joaquin Gage when he came in.
Yeah.
Because
he was a little taller.
Yeah, he was like, a little bit taller, a little bit more jacked.
Like, it was great. That's a great name for him. Yeah,
wow.
Anyway, Bizarro Joaquin Gage was there. And that was really good. All right, let's see here. Let's get to some of the reaction. Let's get to some of the reaction from Jaunty in Victoria. I think the best one that I liked was... this is the version the Beatles intended. The Beatles just never really hit it out of the park with their original. This is what they really wanted.
Yeah, I think if you spin the original backwards, this is what kind of pops out, right? And a banging recipe for a fish casserole as well somewhere in there.
RCN to the inbox and says, that was worth the wait. Bob Loblaw out in Lloyd says, how about a conch for Jaunty and Victoria? So good. So good.
Jaunty might be the conductor in the pit at the Estes. He might just be in charge of the music at this rate.
Yeah, he's not going to win an award.
He should be doing the whole thing.
In charge of the score.
Score the event.
Yeah. that's too good. Hey, another conch. Let's get to this one. Good morning, gents. Can I get a conch for the 7th anniversary of Acme Meats moving into our current location? Corey the Butcher, my man. That's what I'm talking about. 7 years at the current location. Eat fresh, eat local, eat Acme. I got beef coming up at 7:30 this morning.
Drink champagne. You imagine that for Corey and the Butcher and down at Acme Media. Connor Brown scores, and then the next day it's your 7th anniversary. I said turn today into a bit of a party day. They're going to be rocking.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I mean, that's, you got it all going on.
Oh, I love this. There's always the one. There's always the one. That win and the Brown goal was great. However.
Okay.
It was against the Caps. If they did this against the Avs, though, now that would be a reason to climb a light pole or two.
Okay, well, Spruce Grove Corey will counter, guys, if Brown gets on a heater here, 20 isn't off the table this season. So, let's keep it positive here.
That would be that'd be something.
Wouldn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Hey, if you're watching on YouTube this morning, let's hammer that thumbs up, eh? Let's hammer that thumbs up today. We would appreciate it. Give us a sub to the channel as well and tell your friends how easy it is to consume Edmonton Sports Talk. You can watch on YouTube. You can listen to all the podcasts after the fact, but you can also listen live on both iHeartRadio and on TuneIn. I had a few people last night, and I'm like, Connor Brown Gold song coming tomorrow. They're like, man, I really miss those songs you guys did. I'm like, all you have to do is pick up your phone and say, hey, Siri, hey, Google, hey, Alexa, play Edmonton Sports, and that's it. So just tell your friends. That's all you have to do, and then boom, you're laughing. All right, keep the text messages rolling in here, 780-218-9999. Scalding Hot Takes, 840 today. I'm the defending champ, but we're going head-to-head today.
In-season tournament.
So in-season tournament, yeah. You would get the mitt in the in-season tournament, I guess. And then I would still have it for, like,
I gotta
so
find is that,
like, we're trying to unify the championships next week or something?
I got to find that potholders, basically.
Yeah, I mean, we got to have a secondary thing for the
we'll
in-season tournament.
We'll get this
tournament.
Going, yeah.
I could just have to. Anyway, the judge, His Highness, will be by. Mr. Lean's on the move. Maddie today is in monitoring. Zach comes running the show today, but Maddie Iwanek is here for backup
monitoring.
Purposes. Monitoring, yeah. So we're all have to be on our best behavior today.
We
all have to be on our best behavior. The COO is listening and watching today, monitoring the show. We have to be careful. We have to be careful. All right, let's get into your morning announcements for 100.3 The Bear. Edmonton's best rock, 100.3 The Bear. UConn and McCord in the morning, and our Jess Jackson every afternoon. One day we are going to steal her away from the Bear, and she'll come work with us now.
I mean, just a hangout maybe at first, hey? Just
yeah, I mean, yeah, I mean, let's start getting her on the hangout, and then we'll steal her away later. You're right. I guess I'm probably...
Start slow, and then, you know...
Really, I kind of just... I'm skipping
you're
just
ahead. Going straight to the kidnapping.
Skipping ahead here. You know, I probably got to pump the brakes on that a little bit. Last thing I want is like, hey...
You're going to live with me now.
Thanks for the partnership, Bear.
Yeah, yeah.
Taking Jess.
Taking an employee.
You know, where we have to go with the morning announcements here would be the NHL last night. We're going to dive into the award-winning EM Utility Locating morning after show coming up here just after 6:30. And it's award-winning because EM Utility Locating are award winners, not us or the show.
Oh, yeah.
But
they collect the hardware.
So more on that game. But last night in the NHL, very interesting results in the other three games. St. Louis Blues trying to hang on. Bennington made like 40 saves last night.
Yep.
They got by the Kings 3-1. I watched the first two periods start to finish of that Preds-Jets game, and Nashville's 10-0-2 run here is not a fluke.
No, they look good, hey?
My goodness. I don't think anybody will want to play the Nashville Predators.
Well, and you just mentioned
into the playoffs.
You mentioned Bennington as well. You have a goalie like the Preds do as well, and that could be a little dangerous spot
for Saros.
Starting with a wild card, right?
Well, that X factor with Nashville, having watched the first 40 minutes of that game, and I'm not sure how the third played out. But Roman Josi, man, I mean, he took over the first 40 minutes of that hockey game last night. Great stretch pass on the first goal, jumped up into the play on the second goal. Roman Josi is one of those defensemen that can take over a playoff series. Like, I don't think there are, like, there's nobody on the Oilers' blue line. They've got some very good defensemen. Ekholm, obviously steady. Nurse, Bouchard.
Steady? He missed a game.
Like, yeah. Roman Josi can take over.
Yeah.
And I thought he did last night against Winnipeg. So Nashville is now 11-0-2 in their last 13. They are solidifying themselves in the Western Conference playoff picture and have more points than both Vegas and the Los Angeles Kings.
Yep.
So watch out for the Nashville Predators. And then Colorado and Vancouver It ends up going to overtime. We cashed the over 6.5, which was great. Rant the Canucks, though. And this one stings.
Yeah.
JT Miller, McKay Evans, Zadorov, put them up 3-0. And then Colorado just cranks it up a notch. Mikko Rantanen scored with 3 seconds left in the second period.
And it begins.
And then it's McKinnon's 42nd. Then it's Ross Colton. And then it's Nichushkin in overtime. They outshoot them 34-21. And Colorado with the comeback. This reeks of Dallas being up 3 on Florida 2 nights ago. And Florida storming back with 4 in a row. Florida managed to get it done in regulation. Colorado needed overtime last night. But what a win for the Avs. Now they get, man, Saturday night.
Oh,
are you kidding me?
Baby.
Saturday night? McKinnon, McDavid, Rantanen, Dreisaitl, Makar, and some sort of combination of a three-headed monster.
Brown.
Brown and Lehkonen and all these matchups. Saturday night is going to be huge. The Oilers have 2 days off before that game. And you know what? What really works out well, so we can really sort of gauge these teams, Colorado's got 2 games off, 2 days off before this game, too. They don't play again. They played last night, next game against Edmonton. I'm assuming they chill in Vancouver for a day. Probably a nice day off in Vancouver.
But, Canucks get the point, too, but we talk about momentous occasions and big evenings, and Connor Brown with a 7-2 win over the Caps. You look at the Canucks and kind of, you know, letting that one get away in the fashion that it did might... With Thatcher Demko now out, all of these things kind of happening at once. Rough waters out there on the West Coast, hey?
Rough
choppy.
Waters.
It's getting a little choppy.
Super Mario. Hey, boys, epic Tales of the North yesterday. Got the juices flowing for the dub. Now how can I not subscribe? He also has it in there that he bet on a Hyman hat trick last night.
Hey.
And he got it. He got
give us
it.
The numbers.
What a lucky duck. Speaking of Hyman Hattrick, we got a song for that guy, don't we?
Hey, everyone. I'm Zach Hyman of the Edmonton Oilers.
She's so tenacious.
Hope you guys enjoy it.
Revving up his engine, listen to the crowd just roar. No reason for tension, Zach is gonna shoot and score. Hyman's in the scoring zone. Right into the scoring zone. He's signed for 7 years, now he's playing by McDavid's side. He's got you jumping out of your seat cause of that look in his eyes. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. You know he's gonna score a few. Playing with Connor, it's a top line overload. You'll finally see what he can do. So raise your hands up as high as they can go.
He always said that was a magician's secret.
His energy is contagious.
Playing with an edge, that's what you're gonna see. Taking the next step, cause he's no longer with the Leafs. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone.
Oh, Zach Hyman. Oh, he can be a 50-goal guy. It's going to be a 50-goal guy, Zach Hyman.
Burglar says, I think it's more impressive for a guy like Hyman to score 50 than someone like Matthews with a generational shot to score 70.
Oh, wow.
So here we are.
Let's not waste our time on that today. But I like the text.
And as @EDM Oilerlytics points out on Twitter, Connor Brown has more goals than Matthews this week.
Oh, we're full of spicy takes, are we not?
We got the analytics coming out here.
We are full of spicy takes today. All right, you can text us anytime. 780-218-9999. We got the morning after show coming up. All of her songs, of course. Great day for Sportball.
Oh,
a lot of value
for
Sportball
today. Oh,
boy,
we're hitting it.
Yeah, great investment, Sportball partnership
and
here.
And some real good ones. Of course, the Brown song, the debut.
Yeah.
Hyman. I mean, you're playing the hits.
We got more. We got more coming. We got more coming in the second half here. Morning After Show is on the way next. If you're watching on YouTube, hammer thumbs up for us. If you're not yet subbed to the channel, we'd love to have you. It would mean a lot to what we're building over here to get that support. I saw JCD, I think somebody was like, did I miss the Off the Schneid song? You did. You did. But guess what? After he's done this update, I'm playing it again.
Yeah.
I'm playing it again.
High rotation.
Let's get to an update for Green Plan right now with LTE.
Oilers with a big 7-2 win over the Capitals kickstart a four-game homestand. Zach Hyman with a natural hat trick, his fourth hattie of the season, while Connor Brown scoring his first of the campaign. The homestand continues Saturday night. A real barn burner on tap as the Oilers...
Oh, a great barn burner.
A barn burner down at Rogers Place Saturday night. Oilers and Avalanche. Last night, Colorado winning in overtime out in Vancouver, rallying from three down, defeating the Canucks 4-3. Blues top the Kings 3-1. Jordan Binnington, 40 saves. And the Predators double up the Jets 4-2. Nashville up points in 13 straight. Association action saw the Raptors lose to the Pistons 113-104, making five straight losses for Toronto. While Sacramento with a 120-107 victory over the Lakers. Six games around the NBA later tonight. Edmonton Oil Kings with a 6-1 victory down in Lethbridge to cap a four-game road trip. The club return home for a pair Friday against the Hitmen and Sunday against the Swift Current Broncos. Minnesota shutting out Boston 4-0 in PWHL action last night. Schedule will resume Saturday with a pair of games. An opening round of the Players' Championship begins this morning from TPC Sawgrass. Canadian Taylor Pendrith is part of the opening group. Fellow Canadians Corey Connors, Adam Hadwin, Nick Taylor, Adam Svensson, Ben Silverman, and Mackenzie Hughes are also in contention. Sports update for Green Plan with construction season coming up around the corner. Planning season is already in full swing. For all of your environmental planning needs, you can contact Green Plan Environmental Consultants. Green Plan can and will assist with any of your environmental concerns. No matter how big or small the project, Green Plan is here to help. You can check them out today at green-plan.com.
I think we're gonna be glad. I think it's today. Connor Brown scored last night. His dragon is slain. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. He's had chances galore, two and ones and breakaways, yeah. But he could never score, even strength of power play. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. Got to play McDavid line. You should have scored one, you should have scored twice by now. And got to play alongside Dry. How could he not score? How did he not score? How? He's played on every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah. He can never find the twine till he found his last game. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about.
There you go. That's it. That's the Connor Brown Off the Schneid song. Your reaction, of course, 780-218-9999. Get you into the Paris Jewelers inbox. We got Luke Gazdic coming up here just after 7 o'clock. He's buddies with Connor Brown, so he's going to be very excited today. Yeah, people were fired up last night in the on the post game as
But as Bones points out, how about Brown respecting the code and not going nuts on the celebration, even though you know he wanted to?
It might have been different if he'd shot it in as opposed to like, had it bounce off.
We're not really talking about how. That's
the exact goal he needed to score. Right now it really gets those goal-scoring juices flowing.
Yeah. Empty net, skate, whatever.
Richard is in and says, boys, I figure if Brown keeps scoring at this torrid pace, he will surpass Gretzky's all-time goals record in 65,232 games. Move over, Ovi. I like that. Does he have it in him? All right, let's get into your morning after show today. And, yeah, we got a song for that, too.
There's something happening here. The Oilers look a lot better this year. Another win put 2 points on the board, telling me your faith is restored. I think it's time you stop, listen, here we go. Wake up with the morning after show. This year's team's looking strong. Connor and Leon, they can't do no wrong. 6 o'clockers are losing their minds. Getting so many messages on the text line. Think it's time you stop, listen, here we go. Wake up with the morning after show.
Doom, doom, doom. 7-2. The Edmonton Oilers get past the Washington Capitals last night. Your morning after show is brought to you by EM Utility Locating. Recently awarded the Locator of the Year Award in Alberta. Oh, my goodness. Congratulations to Matt and his team over there. If you got a job that's involving something underground that you can't see, and I don't know, you need utilities located, it got you covered. EM Utility Locating. Don't kill yourself. Call 780-222-9497. www.emutilitylocating.com. GPR and concrete scanning, damage prevention, planning, design, education, and training. They got you covered with all of it at EM Utility Locating. Draisaitl opens the scoring on the power play after they just kept feeding him. It's like over and over and over. You're like, stop trying to feed. And they're like, oh, okay, yeah, wicked shot. 1-0.
See, but that's... they think you're going to stop trying to feed him, and then you hit him.
Do it again. You know what? You know what the Capitals won't think? That we try to go to Draisaitl for a fifth consecutive play.
Yeah, yeah.
Boom. Draisaitl.
Nobody had the fifth. Fourth, yeah, maybe. But
cool bet hotline of the day. Cha-ching! Connor McDavid, power play goal, 2-0. Like, okay, it's going to be one of those nights. And then bang, bang! Pow, pow. Bang, bang! Miro Shinichenko and Connor McMichael getting the Caps right back in it. Hyman, 44, 45, 46, followed by Claussen's Angels striking last night.
Pickup man.
Warren Fogle, Ryan McLeod, Leon Draisaitl in on that goal, and then Connor Brown on a night to cap off all nights, just 17 seconds later, goes hard to the net. Evander Kane throws it over, off of Brown's skate, past the goaltender. And the monkey is officially off the bat.
Past the goaltender. No empty net.
Doesn't matter how
we said it may be off a penalty kill rush or something, but he got it past the goaltender and the puck was in the net. That's great.
All right. EST, big moment that happened last night. What are you going with?
Well, I'm
going
to say before the Hyman Hattie. That's Skinner save on Ovechkin. The third shot of the game, man. And it's such at a point where, like, who's to say? But they connect on that. It's three shots, three goals. You're even at three going into the intermission, where it's an intermission. You should be up by three. That to me is a moment. And a moment that Skinner will treasure, I'm sure, as well, just individually. I mean, making that type of save on that type of player who's chasing a player that played. Like, I mean, all of that in its own self moment was just beautiful. I mean, again, you could frame that put on a picture and send it to Pro-Am, and away we go, have a signing. But
it's a great idea, actually.
I think the he made another, but that one too.
The other one he made on Ovi was game was already kind of out of.
Yeah, this though, I mean, again, who's to say if Washington goes back and wins the game?
I still think the Oilers win it.
But it's a different mood going into that intermission, I guess, if you're giving up three goals on three shots there. But that kind of settled things down, I think, for Skinner then too, after allowing 2-1-2. So, I'm going to go with that Skinner save. I know that there are other moments last night, specifically one for Connor Brown.
Well, but, and I'll do that. I mean, I would, if you didn't take the Skinner save, I would have gone Skinner save. Let's go Connor Brown goal last night. Like, everybody was already in a great mood. The party was already on. I'm going to sit here and be like, was there no wave last night? I'm very anti-wave, but I thought last night was Wave City.
There was a butt in the seat.
I was stunned.
There was a butt in the seat. Yeah,
you were there last night. Not a single wave in the house last night.
No, very surprising. I tried getting it started a little bit. My voice is a little rough after that Connor Brown goal, but there wasn't really much of a wave. There was a bit of one that trying to start in the corner. Yeah, but that was about it.
I was surprised last night it wasn't a full-blown wave.
That's the game you
did. Like, this is a good point. Like, I've said multiple times, I'm not anti-wave.
No.
I'm anti-wave in a tight hockey game in the third period. Last night was a full-blown hall pass for a wave, and it just didn't happen. Zach, quickly, you were there, though. What was it like after Connor Brown scored?
Well, I've never cheered louder in my life for an Oilers goal. It was electric. Literally, the building was almost shaking. Everybody started standing up simultaneously, and it was just one of the greatest moments that I've seen as a fan of the Oilers.
Amazing.
Like, I love Connor Brown. Seeing him score is amazing, and everybody seems to love it, so it was great to be there.
It seemed like a pretty awesome... I got home. I watched the first two periods at Hudson's, then I went home and watched the third period at home. So I was just chilling home, and I was like, "Man, this is crazy!" Like,
well, I'm better coming that as opposed to like a 4-1 loss, or is it the lone goal?
Yeah, like,
night like that when everything was kind of sealed up, and give him his.
We're gonna hear from Connor Brown here coming up in a little bit on your EM Utility Locating Morning After Show. Let's get to the super stat of the night. I mean, there's a lot to choose from. Yeah. Rick, where are you going for the super stat of the night, buddy?
Well, and you're right, there is a lot to choose from, and I'll give you a few. The PP. Pretty good numbers there. I mean, y'all will take that. Obviously, the Hyman hat trick, fourth of the season, a natural hat trick for him, in which he continues his pursuit of Austin Matthews, right? I mean, that's real now. What do they have? I'm just going to direct you again as I like to do.
Yeah, what is Matthews at now?
Well, I'll direct you to tsn.ca, wherever I was just going to find. Here it is. Big front page splash. Is it time to admit Matthews won't hit the 70-goal mark?
Oh, I saw that. Yeah, I saw that last night.
And a very dejected-looking Austin Matthews. But, no, the Hyman Hattie, the Brown goal, the power play, how about a 9-2-0? 9-2-0! 9-2-0! 9-2-0! 9-2-0! 9!
A big one. I think the power play's got to be... That's got to be the one.
We've been talking
75%, 3-for-4 last night. Lots of discussion about the power play, even though it's still top five in the league. This is what happens when your city has a really, really, really good hockey team. You look at areas that like probably shouldn't be a concern, but they are because what else is really going wrong, right?
Like, expectations are high. And this week, it's not playoff contention. It's not chasing down a spot. It's going after a Stanley Cup. And I think you shouldn't stop in a strive to perfection.
Especially That's for fair. The PP. Right?
Like, well, yeah, sure. Yeah.
All right, so super sad that I got to kind of look at the power play there. The three stars of the hockey game last night, Zach Hyman with the Hattie, Leon Draisaitl, goal and three assists for 4 points, Connor McDavid, 3 points himself
the,
last
the
night.
The big boys went out there and milked the points. That's what happened. That's kind of
your story. Who's the fourth star?
Well, one shot, 1 point. One goal, one skate, 14 minutes and 20 seconds. It's Connor Brown.
Connor Brown.
You can't deny it. I mean, I'll tip my hat to RNH and an Evan Bouchard and but it's Connor Brown's night. It's Connor Brown's day for crying out loud. Make him the first star. I don't think anybody would have an issue with that last night. These other three get them.
Well, the
every
way the crowd reacted,
anyways.
If they pulled the old all three stars,
you
tonight,
know, yeah,
Connor Brown,
this the place is the would time have gone. To do it. Yeah.
Place would have gone absolutely nuts.
I'll give it to him.
38th star of the game last night. I gotta go Darcy Kemper here. Sporting the 8-1-1.
Well, and the goalie to let Connor Brown score.
I mean, you're the guy.
You're the guy.
All the other goalie brethren texting him today and be like, it's just a Milhouse.
What a loser.
Ha ha. Or whatever it is. Not Milhouse.
Nelson Muntz.
Nelson Muntz. Yeah. You probably do that better than me, eh? Yeah, there it is. That's what we're going for. That's a good one. So Darcy Kuemper will be your 38th star of the game last night. Connor Brown finally found the back of the net. Go hard to the net. Good things will happen, kids. This is why I'm surprised. And he does go hard. This is why I'm surprised he hasn't had this goal yet.
Well, right.
Right? Like, yeah. We're not saying go in and dangle everybody, but finally got one last night.
Hyman goes hard to the net, and he's bagging hat tricks left, right, and
Hyman's a net fiend. Here's what Connor Brown had to say after the game last night.
That's good. I mean, it's just kind of nice to have it behind me. It's nice to get one and contribute offensively, but it's nice to have it in the past. Yeah.
What did you think of the reaction of the fans? It looked like everybody was so happy.
Yeah, it meant a lot. I mean, you play in a big market like this. They're aware of the storylines, and it means a lot. Obviously, it's been a struggle this year offensively. I haven't been able to get one to go, and so obviously for their kind of support to shine through there, and obviously they're rooting for me. So it was a good feeling.
What's it been like? People pay attention in this town, and they know these storylines, like you just said. Yeah. Have people said anything to you? Been encouraging around town? Like, what's your interaction?
Yeah, lots of positive interactions, around town. Lots of people, it's coming, or the ones you get, very positive and supportive. So, it's been great. It's been nice to hear that from the fans. But obviously, sometimes it's a reminder. So it gets tough. But it's like I said, it's nice to get on the board there and just go out and play now.
Has it been hard to keep belief in yourself that goal's coming? Have you had nights when you thought, man?
That's the challenge, obviously. But I believed in myself. I know that I was just focused on feeling better, getting faster, stronger, playing better, and I know that I'm around the net enough that one's going to pop in, and then I know that I can build from that and gain some confidence with the puck in the scoring areas, and so it's nice to get that now in the right time of year and start rolling.
Well, you've found a niche in the team, and you've got a role, and you're playing a regular shift and all those things. You didn't come here to score 50. No one expected that, but it's still difficult when you're an NHL guy getting this much ice time not to score. Like, I know goal scoring is not a huge part of your game, but does it become a bigger part when it doesn't go in?
Well, I've scored 20 multiple times in my career, so I would say it is a big part of my game. So, I never was just, never just okay with not scoring. I wasn't, sufficient with just kind of, letting these big boys take the load and not trying to contribute. I'm trying to score every night, and it'll be that way moving forward and into the playoffs.
What's your message from the coaching staff through this? Because Chris has, we asked him about you, and he's always talked about the role you have and how valuable the kill is. And how's he sort of been with you through this?
And Aubrey's been great. He's been great with me. He's been helpful, supportive. I mean, I really honestly hasn't really talked to me about it much. Just kind of conversations I have with him are kind of within my role in the team and what's kind of needed out of me on this team. And that's kind of where our conversation's been.
All right, there you go. That is Connor Brown last night. You got to feel good for the guy. I mean, you have to feel good for the guy. The reaction was, I liked his answer, I think, to Speck's question when he said, well, I've scored 20 goals multiple times in the National Hockey League. Goal scoring is supposed to be a part of my game. And that's, good for him to still have the confidence that, I can score goals. Like, I should be scoring goals.
Yeah, and clearly a guy that hasn't shied away from this. I mean, he knows what, he's heard it, he's seen it, he's read it, he's smelled it. It's all been the story, but yes, that's what he does. That's what he was brought in to do at the money that he gets paid, and I don't think that must have sat easy with him. There must have been some hard nights and some hard self-reflection, but I mean, again, I think a guy in Zach, too, I love him. He is a guy that it's tough to hate because he has been trying. And he has been doing some good things, namely on the PK. So good on him for kind of owning that as well.
Tay-Tay texts in today to the inbox. By the way, we are just under an hour away from the keyword for the Vegas trip. Ooh. EST, Flyway to Vegas with FlyYEG. Keyword around 7:45 today. Tell your friends. Maddie said it's a great keyword because it's not a league name today. We gotta get a mic on Awanek sitting out on the couch.
Oh, he's spicy out there.
He's just sitting out there, chiming in on
monitoring.
Things.
Yeah, yeah.
Tay-Tay says the show of support from Oilers fans for Brown. Why would a player not want to play here? That's in from Tay-Tay. Now I would say that because I know on the call last night, this is why players want to play here. I get it, but I mean. these players spend a lot of the time under the microscope getting absolutely ripped by the fan base as well. You know, it's the best of both worlds. When you're in a city that's as passionate about their hockey team as this one is, I can see a lot of reasons why the pressure would probably be so much that players don't want to play here. But when something like that happens last night, you're like, man, it is worth it when you get this type of reaction. You know, like,
you're good with the bad,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, exactly. There's both ways you can do it.
Everything negative is going to be magnified times 100, and everything good, maybe, scoring your first of the season, as you do, it might be magnified as well the other way. But the fishbowl.
If you can take the good with the bad as a player here, then you'll probably enjoy
it. It's an aquarium. Is what we got going on here, hey?
That is what it's like. They're all swimming around.
And very expensive
fish. How come that Connor Brown fish just keeps sucking on the window over here on the glass?
I paid $3 million for it.
That fish is really not getting the job done.
Boy.
Yeah. No, that's... but I mean, Tay-Tay, I see where you're coming from there, but I do think, like, just because there was a great reaction last night, you can't go be like, the players have it great here.
you can stop the pendulum swinging yourself by just
saying,
Two weeks ago,
somebody texted in, wanted to trade Leon Draisaitl for Sidney Crosby.
Sure, yeah.
So, like...
And people were
it goes both ways.
Attaching swear words to Connor Brown's name. So, I mean, it's...
Yeah, I mean, Connor Brown has been absolutely raked by everybody. I mean, and we're not saying the media is not involved in that either, right? No. So, yeah. No, I think it's good. Connor Brown scored his goal because he knew Tommy needed to get over his time change issues. That's nice. You got to get
one. This for you, Tom.
Got to get one,
points
Tommy.
To the
waves. Yeah. Yeah, that was for Tommy Gazzola. By the way, I think Tommy kind of got over it last night. Last night, if you go watch him on the post game, like he good color in his skin again.
Yeah.
Like he was really looking good last night. Yeah, Tommy Gazzola.
The blood has returned.
Yeah,
to the head.
No, I think it's pretty good. I like that. All right, Draisaitl had one last night, didn't he?
Yeah.
Leon scored a goal tonight. Watching him play is quite a sight. You know this song is tight. Oilers fans, come on. You've loved him endlessly since he was drafted number 3. He's a center with a size that was born in Cologne. Try to stop him, you can't do much more. That ain't no lie. You just wanna see him shoot and score. It was try, try, try. Gonna make a fool out of you. Probably score a goal and assist on 2. You can't stop him, and that ain't no lie. Cause it's try, try, try. Don't even try to play him rough. Leon is a German, so you know he's tough. His hands are crazy, and Aikens loves his eyes. Yeah, it's try, try, try. Gonna make a fool out of you. Probably score a goal and assist on 2. You can't stop him, and that ain't no lie. Cause it's try, try, try. Don't even try to play him rough. Leon is a German, so you know he's tough. His hands are crazy, and Aikens loves his eyes. Yeah, it's try, try, try.
Draisaitl goal song. Some of you have popped into the Nasty Gym, be like, I'm here for the Connor Brown goal song. I mean, if you're watching on YouTube, you can just scroll back and get it. If you are listening on TuneIn or on iHeart, we'll have it for you again in the 7 o'clock hour. We got Luke Gazdic coming up just after 7 o'clock today as well. We'll get his thoughts on Connor Brown. Finally, burying one. We'll get your Cool Bet Hotline of the day coming up. I got beef in the 7:30 hour today as well. And that keyword, if you like to fly away with EST to Vegas and our partners at the airport, FlyYEG. Keyword coming up, first of 4 chances today for you here on Edmonton Sports Talk, coming up around 7:45. Again on the Hangout. Hangout today, Gager and Majot. Oh, I love it.
Love it.
I love it. You guys are going to talk Dune. I haven't seen the first Dune.
You got to get on that, man.
Yeah.
You're going to love
that.
Well,
what I want to talk about is Majot not doing podcasts lately. It's driving me nuts. I know he's got a kid.
He's tired.
I know.
Oh.
When I had, well, I got 2 days off. I remember that. And then I was back to work. So, yeah. What's that? Yeah.
2 kids and 1 day off?
Babies aren't that important. Well, hey. Anyway, I mean, I'm just a huge fan of the MCTV podcast. The boys haven't dropped one in like over 10 days.
I think
like,
that's how you frame
come
it.
Come on, man.
I think that's how you frame it. I'm a huge fan. Yeah. When can I expect?
Well, nothing. I am. It's my favorite podcast. Like, anyway, Mark Bergeau and Joaquin Gage on the Hangout today. Lock Shop and then two guys and a goalie a little bit later on as well. A chance to qualify for the trip to Vegas on all four of those. We had two guys named Colin qualify yesterday. Which was really weird.
Call in?
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I know. Like, Trev was going to make that joke. And then again, I was like, are you the same Colin that qualified earlier today? And maybe it was, and he was just pretending it wasn't.
Oh.
Actually, no. We saw the names after. He wasn't. Yeah, okay. So anyway, two Colins yesterday.
Two Colins. Both double L, one L? Not that it matters.
I don't know. I like parents to name a baby Colin C-A-L-L-I-N just to be hilarious.
Yeah.
But I guess
that'd be a new wave of Colins, right? Like, that's probably...
Yeah.
You know, like Tyson spelled differently nowadays, too.
The same type. Yeah, well, how's Tyson spelled now?
Well, you can have like an A, an I, an E.
But it's it should be an O.
You, sure, whatever.
I bet you there's somebody out there that spells Tyson T-I-S-E-N.
Well, that's what I'm saying. Colin wouldn't be.
People are ridiculous.
Wouldn't sneeze at that.
People are ridiculous. Guys, watching Connor Brown score is like watching that tier 6 U9 kid who never touches the puck finally put one in. It brings out all the feels.
Sure.
It really does. First time that person's ever texted in. Welcome aboard. Tell your friends about EST. I retweeted a video last night of McDavid at high speed on the power play, picking up the puck through the neutral zone. Like, it looked like everybody else was in slow motion, and he was just cruising. And I said, he looks like a tier one kid playing in tier four. Like, you're just like, that guy's, McDavid's been tiered wrong. He's been tiered wrong. We got to get him with his peers.
The second you say that, again, we all identify that when there's that one.
You always know. You're like, oh, yeah, that's what that's like.
Just slicing up the middle.
All of you had that guy that you played hockey with when you were like 9 who should have been playing with the 11-year-olds. And you're like,
just, the defenders just like fall down. As he skates towards the guy.
Like, what are you supposed to do?
It's too much. You can't do anything.
The goalie's just like, what am I going to do here? What am I supposed to do? Christian is in and says, I got to see Dune 2 and the Oilers yesterday. It was a great night. What
Holy
a great day.
Heck.
That's what is that? Yeah, an afternoon movie and then the game last
that's
night?
A that's a long day. Is, yeah.
That's that a long time. Day.
Yeah.
But congratulations on your free time. That's amazing. 780-218-9999. You got to get in the mixer text of the day today.
Atif in the nasty chat just texts Connor Brown's name twice. So
that's not the key word, Atif.
Atif's rolling.
Yeah,
he's on fire this morning.
Man in the chair is ready to deliver today.
Connor Brown.
This is kind of like a little sneak peek here. After 7 o'clock today, we've got an AM Nasty exclusive offer from Pro-Am that Jack texted me last night and basically just said, we're not going to advertise this anywhere else, so pass it along on your show tomorrow.
Hot dog.
So we're going to lay that out for you just after 7 o'clock today. So we'll get into that. Keyword 7:45. Gazdic on the way just after 7 o'clock this morning. Conch for everybody joining us here in the 6 o'clock hour today. This is great. If you missed the Connor Brown goal song, we'll have it for you again sometime in between 7 and 7:30 this morning. Keyword 7:45. Luke Gazdic on the other side. Right now, a sports update for an upcoming curling event. It starts in less than a week right here in our wonderful city.
Connor Brown scoring his first of the season. Zach Hyman with his fourth hat trick of the season. As the Oilers soundly defeat the Capitals 7-2 to kick off a four-game homestand. It'll continue Saturday night as the Avalanche roll into town. Colorado winning in overtime last night out in Vancouver, as they'd rally from 3 down, defeating the Canucks 4-3. Elsewhere, the Blues over the Kings 3-1, and the Preds, they have points in 13 straight following a 4-2 victory over the Winnipeg Jets. Toronto Raptors, they've now dropped 5 straight following a 113-104 loss to the lowly Pistons. Kings defeating the Lakers 120-107, 6 games around the NBA later tonight. Back over to hockey, where the Oil Kings capped the 4-game road trip with a 6-1 win down in Lethbridge. The club are back home for a pair Friday against the Hitmen and Sunday against the Swift Current Broncos. Minnesota shutting out Boston 4-0 in PWHL action last night. Schedule will resume Saturday with a pair of games. Opening round of the Players' Championship beginning this morning from TPC Sawgrass. Canadian Taylor Pendrith is part of the opening group, while a handful of Canadians will also join him in the field. The Edmonton Blind Curling Club is hosting the 50th Western Canadian Blind and Vision Impaired Curling Championships. It'll run from March 20th to 23rd at the Granite Curling Club. Come out and support visually impaired athletes as they look to become champions of the West.
The Nielsen Show featuring Lieutenant Eric. Only on Edmonton Sports Talk.
On a Thursday morning, Dusty and Lieutenant Eric with you. If you're watching on YouTube, hammer the thumbs up for us. Sub to the channel. We love it. Working our way up towards 7,300 subs on the YouTube channel. And of course, if you are listening on iHeart or on TuneIn or at EdmontonSportsTalk.com, all we ask of you is that you tell your friends how easy it is to consume the EST content. If you're here for that trip to Vegas, keyword coming up around 7:45 today. So if you want to qualify to get in the mix to possibly win three nights accommodations, nonstop flights for two, and tickets to a Cirque show, and the flexibility to book that bad boy anytime in the next year, be listening for that around 7:45. If you missed Connor Brown Gold Song, we'll run that back here just before 7:30 as well. And the Cool Bet Hotline of the day, man, we are on fire this week. 3 for 3 with the Cool Bet Hotlines of the day. Drysdale goal paying off last night for us. That'll happen around 7:20. And I got beef 7:30 today for Acme Meats. So basically, Zach Hyman special here is what we've got. At Pro-Am right now, all of our hockey insiders all year long brought to you by Pro-Am Sports. But for the next 3 days, and they're not promoting this anywhere else, so it's for you listening right now. For the next 3 days, in-store only, so yeah, I got to go visit them, St. Albert Trail, 128th Ave, just north of the Yellowhead. It's the EST Hat Trick Special. 30% off Oilers hats. Thursday, Friday, Saturday. 30% off Oilers hats. Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. In-store only at Pro-Am Sports. So go visit them today, tomorrow, or on the weekend on Saturday. And they're dropping 30% off on Oilers hats. It's the EST Hat Trick Special, available only at Pro-Am. St. Arbor Trail, 128th Ave. Go visit them and get a new lid. Get that pre-playoff lid.
Very thoughtful. Right? I love it. Or get a few extra Hyman lids that in case of when his next hat trick happens, that you've got an extra one to toss on the ice, right? You have a box of Hyman hats.
Basically, like, let's say you buy three. You get 30% off each one. You get a fourth one. It's basically free.
There you go. That's basically quick math there on that puppy.
Oh, we got to get to Luke Gazdic here. He's got a kitty cat with him.
Let's
bring in Gazdic. Look at this guy. Luke, what's going on, buddy? How you doing, man?
What's up, boys? This is Cash.
Okay, Cash. Named after...
That's a little Cash.
Johnny Cash or money or why Cash?
Yeah, that's Johnny Cash, buddy. I love any animal named after your musician. That's it for
me. That's your thing, hey?
Love it.
Trying to think if I ever had an animal named after a musician.
Well, you also had an orange cat, though, back in the day.
Yeah, actually, he looked just like, I hope my wife wasn't watching, she'll get emotional, because he looked just like Jazz, our fat old orange tabby. He was a great cat. Hated my guts. And I didn't really like him much either, but a nice cat to have around.
Had respect for each other.
He was my wife's cat. I married into that relationship.
Game
he never liked me.
Game, yeah.
Never liked me ever. So, yeah, what are you going to do? Only so much. The Edmonton Oilers last night pumping the Washington Capitals. We'll get to Hyman in a second. We'll get to the power play in a second. Skinner saves on Ovi. We'll get to that. Connor Brown.
Hey, You have a segment, I've Got Beef. Can we start there?
Yeah, sure. What do you got beef with, buddy?
What time is 10 o'clock game start?
Oh, man.
What's going on here?
I know, right? Like,
boys, I'm on Eastern time over here.
Yeah.
Like, I can't be staying up all hours of the night waiting for this thing to start. The Avs Canucks game that started at 10:30 almost finished at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. It is. It was, what was it, 22 puck drop or something like that?
Because it's terrible. And good on you for joining us, though, bright and early the next day, which doesn't go unnoticed at
all.
And
I can't imagine a game like that, though, and you're sitting around waiting for it to start till 10:22 p.m.
We complain enough.
But that's nuts.
At 8:22 p.m.
I love our time zone for sports.
Yeah.
Our time zone for sports is awesome. I could see the East being pretty pissed off about that.
LT, yeah. I'm a professional. That's what I do, buddy.
No. Absolutely. But I'm just saying it doesn't go without notice. We complain, too, 8:22, but at 10:22. Yeah. Ain't having it.
Tommy Gazzola would not be able to operate if he had to do an Oilers postgame show that started at like 1 in the morning.
Not happening.
There's just no chance. He would just be dead to the world. So, but last night it was worth the squeeze for everybody who was here at the rink last night as Connor Brown, go to the net and good things will happen. That's why I said to Eric this morning, I said, I'm surprised that hadn't happened for him already, right? Because it's not like he doesn't go to the net. He just hasn't had a bounce yet, and he got one last night.
Yeah, I'm not going to lie, boys. That was a really, really cool moment. I think the fans really leaned into it, too. Like, that's I mean, I listened to the back end of what you guys were saying before I got on here. I think that's what's such a special thing about playing at Edmonton is, you know, fans and media can be all over you at times, especially when you go through stretches individually or as a team. But when things are going good and big moments like that happen, they really respect and appreciate it. And I thought that was always one of the coolest things about playing there. Like last night, every single person in the building knows that he's gone through his goal scoring struggles. And I think, I don't even know if Knobs, did he call a timeout or something? Like there was obviously extended time after that. And I just thought it was so cool how they soaked it in and he soaked it in. And it was really cool, man.
Well, you know, just take us back and put us back in your playing days here. The managing of when it's great, it's great. And when it's not great, you know, people can get on you pretty good. Does it even out in the end? Like, is it worth the squeeze as a player to have those great, like a playoff run here? You know, it's always amazing. I mean, these guys are, you know, heroes in the city. But when things aren't going like the start of this year, being here in October, man, must have sucked for a player. So was it worth it? How do you manage that?
Listen, man, I'll tell you, I played in a number of different spots over my career, and not everyone is like me. I think there's some guys that like to hide and like to be a lot more discreet, especially away from the rink, but I wouldn't have had it any other way than playing in a place like E-Town where you walk around and fans will stop you on the street and talk to you about hockey. You really are under the microscope. I know you guys called it the aquarium, I think I heard earlier, but... Listen, it can be challenging at times, especially through the dark times. I mean, when I was there, we had some tough stretches, but I wouldn't have it any other way. I would love to have a fan base like that that's passionate and is all in for your team rather than leaving the rink and nobody knowing who you are. I watched this firsthand when Taylor got traded to Jersey and I followed him signing in free agency. I remember asking him because I was in the hotel and he had already moved into his place. I said, how is it in Hoboken? Are you walking around? Are people recognizing you? And he said, not one single person has come up to me yet and said, hey, you know, are you so-and-so? So it just goes to show different markets are different for everybody. But man, I absolutely loved it. And I'll take the engaging fan base any day of the week.
Well, Luke, let's get into some of these new acquisitions and, you know, talking to you last week, it was kind of, you know, after the Henrique, the Carrick and all of that. And you certainly said what you said, albeit knowing these guys in your career and previous. But what have you made a week out? Of course, a few fans this morning suggesting, too, that a lot of these guys, Henrique, haven't really been noticeable. But I don't think that's why they were brought in to be noticeable. It was just to add it a little bit of insurance and you know, the bottom to make your better guys better. What have you thought of the new acquisitions during this week? Stetcher getting some game time last night as well, Ekholm under the weather, but your thoughts on the new guys thus far a week in?
Yeah, I think these are all three players that are going to take time to notice how good they're going to be throughout the lineup. I don't think this is superstar acquisitions that are going to come in and blow your socks off right away, but particularly Adam's game. I think Rico has gotten better and better as we've gone along here. I thought he had a really strong game last night, made some really nice plays. It's good to see he's getting some penalty kill time, because that's where he can really excel. And I know Sammy Carrick got scratched already once, but I thought he was solid on the PK last night too, skating well, starting to get his feet. Stetch had a bit of a tough night taking the two tripping penalties, but yeah, you know, we'll take that. Guys will kill that off for him. And I think these guys are just going to get better and better as we go. This is my really first hand look at Rico in a while too. Not saying I didn't watch any Ducks games this year, yeah, but I mean, just being exposed to him for the first time, watching every single shift, and he's going to bring a lot. Sometimes, like, there were games like that for me where I had to be noticed. If I was not noticeable, I was doing something wrong. But there are particular players that sometimes it's a good thing if you don't notice them the whole game. It necessarily means that they haven't made huge mistakes. They aren't glaringly out of place. And I think that's kind of been the case a little bit, but I think we're going to see better and better hockey as we go down with these guys.
I thought Stetcher got put into a bit of a tough spot tonight, having to play offside, or last night, offside, kind of short notice. You know, not the ideal way to break yourself in with a new club, right?
Also, yeah, even the mentality of it and the mental about not really knowing if you're going to play.
Yeah.
I would assume that, you know, they gave him a heads up and said, listen, Ecky's not feeling great, you might be going. But even that, still, in my mind, like, that happened a number of times where they're like, hey, so-and-so is nursing this and he woke up with a cold, like, you might be going. That's different than walking in and seeing your number on the board and knowing you're going that night. And I think just a mentality of that, of having to jump in and it's your first game. And I mean, what a better situation for him, right? It's not, they weren't playing Colorado on Saturday night, right? You're playing Washington on a Thursday. So I thought he did as well as he could, but yeah, it can be tough to just jump in like that last minute.
So with Henrique here now, they've put him the last few games on the third line with Evander Kane, and then elevated Fogel and McLeod to play with Drysdale. They scored a nice 5-on-5 goal last night. What do you make of that group? And is that something that you think will stick and come opening night of the playoffs? Drysdale is centering McLeod and Fogel.
Yeah, it's interesting in the middle six, right? I love that line that he threw together last night with Rico and Kane and Brownie. I think that has the potential. They've really been looking for this, right? They're looking for a good third checking line. And that's not even necessarily a checking line. There's a checking line that can give you some offense as well. On paper, McLeod, Fogel, Drysdale to me doesn't look great. Like, when I'm putting together some stuff and notes and prep, and I'm like, oh, you know, maybe he can play with him. It doesn't look great. I've said this before, I'll say it again. I don't love wingers playing their offside unless you're Leon Draisaitl or someone like that. It's a really hard job to do in the NHL. Everything's on your peripherals. You play the majority of the game on your backhand. It takes a special type of player to do that, but they've really excelled. You really have to kind of know what you're doing when you're playing with Leon. Just go to the net, like, give him the puck, win battles, make sure he's getting the puck, and it's really worked out. And I'm just interested to see what happens with that fourth line too. Listen, if you're going to pick out one negative, and I hate to go after a fourth line because I played for them, the fourth line wasn't great last night. I think they know that. But if they're going to have any success, they got to have a four-pronged kind of attack here. So I think it's going to be interesting how Knob shuffles not only the middle and see if he keeps that together, but finds a fourth line. Listen, he said, sorry, one more thing, but he said before the game, consistency in your lineup is key. So, you know, he wants to get a lineup here and really ride them into the playoffs. So it'll be interesting to see what happens.
Luke Gazdic with us from Sportsnet, Mid-South Podcast as well. Did last night kind of sum up Alexander Ovechkin's season? Like, Skinner absolutely took a couple of goals off the board last night.
Yeah, I think, well, it's a good way to put it. And we've watched him all year. It's obviously a step. He's a little bit of a step behind. He's starting to lose it a bit, but those are three great A's. And I give Stu more of the credit for that than I do Ovi being snake bitten. Like, those were three massive saves. And Stu has started to do this on a consistent basis. Got to give him a lot of credit, especially last night. I think that game could have gone completely differently. Two goals on two shots to start wasn't pretty, but man, I want to see, I didn't want to see him score all three of those last night, but I'm loving watching this goal chasing record. And Stoff put it great. Him and Mac T were talking about it in between the second and third. Like, it's going to come a time here for Washington where the goals of the team are going to separate from the goals of Ovi. And it's good. We're all talking about Pittsburgh, but it's going to be interesting to watch what happens with Washington as well, because at some point they're going to have to be like, you know, what are we doing?
Yeah.
Here?
Yeah. 2 years left after this year at 9.5 and 55 goals back of Wayne Gretzky's record. I know in this town, and I'm assuming you're pretty fired up, but Colorado last night, 4 unanswered to come back and beat the Canucks. They have 2 days off. The Oilers have 2 days off. And then on Saturday night, it's Colorado and Edmonton. First of 3 down the stretch between these two clubs. I mean, I can't, that should be an incredible hockey game, right?
It's going to be unreal. There's just certain games that, you know, when I was a player and now working as an analyst, that you literally circle on the calendar ahead of time as you're looking at the schedule and going about your business. And this is one of them, man. They scored 4 unanswered against Calgary 2 the night before. And this is a team that's on a back-to-back last night. Like,
yeah,
back-to-backs in the NHL are no joke. I know people like to poke fun at that. Oh, you fly on a charter and you stay in nice hotels and you have all the food in the world. But playing back-to-back games in the NHL is a hard task to accomplish. And to score 4 like that, they got 1, you know, 3 seconds left in the second, but that's who this team is. Those two guys in McKinnon and McCarr can change the dynamic and flow of a game instantly, like at the snap of a fingers. Nate has been unreal to watch this year. And every time I turn on the abs, I find myself just staring at number 8, just watching McCarr and just thinking, like, there's nobody that I've seen play defense like this. It's unbelievable. And so they can go quiet a little bit. And they just have, that killer instinct in them to flip the momentum of a game at any moment. So this should be a great match on Saturday. I know the big boys, I know Connor loves to get fired up for big tests like this and chasing them in the Art Ross and all the rest. So I'm fired up for it.
Yeah, it's going to be a good one. Thanks for the time. Nice to meet Cash, and you guys have a good morning.
Thanks, boys. Have a good day.
Right, there you go. That's Luke Gazdic. Sportsnet Mitsoff podcast brought to you by Pro Am Sports, where they have that deal right now. 30% off Oilers hats in store only Thursday through Saturday. For all you AM nasties out there,
buy 3 get 1.
They're only advertising this deal right here.
Love it.
On the Nielsen Show. So let's do this. Swing on by, just north of the Yellowhead. You turn north off the Yellowhead onto St. Albert Trail, right up on the left at 128th Ave. Pop in, see the Cooks and Boys. 30% off Oilers hats, and now would be the time to go in and get a new Oilers lid or two, and be ready for as we call it around here, and we have for a couple months now. The cup run. Playoffs be damned. It's a cup run. You can chime in anytime. We got the keyword coming up here in just over 25 minutes for Vegas. I know many of you are here today for the Connor Brown Off the Schneid song. And we're gonna hit it again here right now. And we've been waiting how long? Like, you've been waiting the entire season to see the guy score. But we've had this song sitting here for 2 weeks now. And the temptation to play it was very much out there.
Yeah.
But it was worth the wait. It was worth the wait.
We were trying not to, and we didn't. And yeah. Here we are.
Off the Schneid, Connor Brown song.
I think we're going to be glad. I think it's today. Yeah. Connor Brown scored last night. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about time. He's had chances galore. 2-1s and breakaways, yeah. But he could never score. even strength or power play. He's finally out to shine. He's finally out to shine. Connor Brown's off of the shine. It's about time. He got to play McDavid live. He should've scored one, he should've scored twice by now. And got to play alongside Drive. How could he not score? How did he not score? On every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah, he could never find the twine till he found his last game. Yeah, he's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time.
Do we need the beep?
I don't know.
Upon listening for the third time,
I have to say, I mean, those beeps aren't.
They're not doing the job.
I don't know if those beeps are right where they're supposed to be. Yeah, I don't know if those beeps are right where they're supposed to be.
This is like a Dick Benner overtime call here.
They're there.
Oh, yes,
but I don't know if they're where they're supposed to be. But they are there.
They're more for show than anything at this point. Eh?
Yeah. Anyway, there you go. That's Connor Brown off the Schneid song. Your text messages, 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. Jonty does it again. It's that simple. Jonty does it again. The man is a EST legend.
The maestro.
Having Jonty just dropping songs on us all the time makes me happy that we were all let go from 1260, right? We never had this at 1260. Jonty was never doing this at 1260, but he does it for us here.
Well, it would be loud.
It's great. Well, yeah, that's the thing. That's the thing. Like, probably would not have been approved. So, no, it's good. 780-218-9999. Hey, let's do this in the text line right now as well. If you want to win a skate sharpening card for 10 sharpenings. Northern Edge Athletics, independent hockey shop located in Argyle Arena. For those looking for services, passionate about the game as you are, they specialize in skate sharpening, skate and equipment repair, as well as hockey lifestyle wear. Stay sharp with Northern Edge Athletics. And all you have to do is text in right now, cut me, 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. Text in, cut me, and we'll draw one of your names. You will win a sharpening card for 10 skate sharpenings over at Northern Edge Athletics in Argyle. JCD 780. Those beeps were about as effective as Darcy Kemper last night.
Give him a minute.
Real nice. Real nice. So here's the one thing. And Doofishpay, I see your message there about the Preds. We talked about it in the morning announcements today for 100.3 The Bear. I don't think I'll ever not laugh at that ever. I mean, you always get a chuckle out of me. I shouldn't even have thrown it to you.
Reminds you of Dave Jameson, to be honest with you.
Does that remind you, J-Mo?
Yeah.
The Preds are 11-0-2 in their last
points in the 13. Yeah, 13 straight.
They've been rolling.
Yeah.
Doesn't seem likely they catch that top three in their division, but they're going to end up being a tough out. But here's, like, I think we have to, so let's say, I mean, the Colorado reaction, and I'm going to be on post game Saturday night for the Colorado game.
Oh, I love this.
I can't wait. I'm going to be fired up.
Spicy.
Like, I'm looking forward to it. That's a big game.
Oh, wow.
Hopefully there's some great storylines. I'll be fired up for post game Saturday night. Maddie's doing pre. I'm going to do post on Saturday. God. And, but, like, next week, if they were to lose to Buffalo or Montreal or whatever, and I know the morning after would come in and everybody would be freaking out. Mm-hmm. But I think what we have to learn here over the last, I don't know, like, 3 months now, is that, yeah, they might have an off game, but they've been pretty good at bouncing back. Like, stretch here over the last 45, I mean, how many regulation losses?
That's the thing. It could be the biggest bounce back ever. The bounce back from the start of the year. So at this point, you go in that winning streak, which, again, happened, I think, at a good time of the season, too, where you're not I mean, I don't think you want to carry something like that in the playoffs. Yes, you want to be playing well, but to be like, you know, like I just think people focus on the streak, they focus on that number. Whereas I think for this club, you know, having a loss here or there, there's nothing wrong. They battled back into position where they can get a playoff spot now, maybe even higher. So you've done that. That's the bounce back. They're going to drop a few along the way. That's just going to be how it is. But if you're losing a game once every week, once every 2 weeks, when the schedule is packed and thick, I think most fans would take it at this point. And if they continue to keep trending the way they're trending, you have an off day or an off night or whatever, a night in Columbus like they did, you come out a little flat. But these tests Saturday night against Colorado, I mean, that's where you want to see the DNA really come to play and what they're made of. So I think, yeah, looking ahead again, next Tuesday, Montreal in town, Buffalo visit on Thursday. Then you're out in Toronto for a Saturday night affair against the Leafs. But I think the bounce back was at the beginning of the year where they bounced back. They've got that winning streak. That's come and gone. I think if you're just trucking down now towards the playoffs and you're playing at, you know, I don't know, give me a winning percentage clip, but it doesn't have to be a one. It doesn't have to be perfect. Just keep milking the points, staying where you're staying around. I don't know, like, do you care at this point where you're finishing standings-wise? Saying last night, too, we talk about the Kings, we talk about the Golden Knights, as we should, but, you know, then you get this Preds team that are playing really good. They have a hot goalie. Who's to say? I mean, this can happen. The Nashville Predators could be a thorn in the side. Who knows? But I think that the Oilers just continue doing what they're doing. Drop one here or there. Keep yourself hungry. It's good. They bounced back. The bounce back of all bounce backs.
What say you? 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. We'll get to your Cool Bet hotline of the day. Coming up after 7:30, we got I Got Beef for Acme Meats. Got that Vegas keyword. We're going to talk a little bit. If you go to TSN.ca right now, Dave Naylor has an article on the Elks seeking private ownership for the first time in franchise history. They're having a committee kind of look at it. Now it looks like that's it. Like the committee has decided that, all right, it's time to find private ownership for this group. So you think that's the best thing that could happen for the Elks right now? 780-218-9999. Keyword for Vegas in about 13 minutes time here as well. We've been rolling this week on the Cool Bet hotline of the day. We are a perfect 3-for-3. My lock shot play of the day is over in the Cool Bet socials, 3-for-3. It's just been a real nice week. You have these weeks, right? You get on a heater for a bit. And then as it is with pretty much everything in life, but sports betting as well, you know, ups and downs along the way. But when the ups are hidden, it's real nice. Real nice. All right, so what do we got? We got, as we like to say in the biz, a full slate in the National Hockey League tonight. Islanders, Sabres, Panthers, Hurricanes, Sens, Jackets, Coyotes and the Red Wings, Bruins and the Habs, Sharks and the Penguins, ugh, Rangers and the Lightning, Maple Leafs and the Flyers, Devils and the Stars, Ducks and the Wild, Vegas and the Golden Knights, and Washington has to go into Seattle and play the Kraken tonight after getting bare butt spanked at Rogers' place last night. I think I know where I want to go here. I think we're going to go, yeah, let's go here. Sidney Crosby to score a goal tonight. Minus 100. I mean, right up. Like, in the last 8 games, Sid has like 2 points. The Penguins get the San Jose Sharks tonight.
The Erik Karlsson Bowl.
If yeah. Who really won that deal? if Sidney Crosby is going to get off the mini schneid that he's on, it's happening tonight for the Pittsburgh Penguins against the San Jose Sharks. So let's ride with Sid the Kid to score tonight for your Cool Bet hotline of the day. Find that over at CoolBet. If you're not yet signed up for an account at CoolBet,
oh no,
use the code LOCKSHOP when you do. What's your own?
Some news on that game as well. The Penguins announcing that the shipment carrying Jaromir Jagr bobbleheads for tonight's game against the Sharks has been stolen on its way to Pittsburgh.
Come on.
Yeah.
Come on. What? Are you making this up?
Yeah, no. This is official. As a result, the team says the bobbleheads will not be distributed, no doubt, at tonight's game and will instead be handed out at a latter date.
So they're reordering or are they just hoping to find it?
At this point, they don't know. The shipment carrying the bobbleheads has been stolen en route to Pittsburgh, and they will not be handing out the Jagr bobbleheads tonight. There's a quote here, if you'd like me
I actually really want the quote.
Penguins President of Business Operations, Kevin Acklin, chimes in. We were shocked to be a victim of cargo theft, and we are working closely with local and federal authorities on the investigation. He'd go on to add, while this unfortunate incident adds to the legend of Jaromir Jagr, who will be in attendance as our guest at tonight's game, we look forward to resolving this theft and delivering the prized bobbleheads to their rightful homes with our fans. More to come.
First suspects have to be those traveling Jagrs, right?
I'd put them on the list. I mean, I'd have to be.
I know we had a few of them in here on the
in-person interview. Yeah,
you'd have it's got to be. Those guys at least are getting brought in for questioning.
Yeah,
has to be.
Or
who,
just like a,
who steals? Imagine if they thought they were stealing something else, and they steal this load, and they're like, "We got it, boys. We've made it." Yes, and they cut it, and they're expecting like diamonds,
Bitcoins.
And they open it up, and it's like Jaromir Jagr bobbleheads. What am I going to do with these?
Good luck selling them on the
how do you move
the
those?
Aftermarket.
How do you move those? This is the worst thief, the worst robbery of all time.
A bunch of drunk Flyers fans or something, eh? Trying to
wow. All right.
So there's that. Just to add on to the, I don't know if that affects.
I think it motivates Sid even more.
I think that would.
I think it motivates Sid even more.
Yeah.
Do it for the Jagr bobblehead thieves. Boy, that's interesting one.
Yeah.
All right.
Well, federal authorities, not just we're going to the top, baby.
Yeah, this is a federal case.
The feds are getting in on this.
How about the FBI agent that gets said, hey, man, you're going out to work that Jagr case.
that Jagr case.
Yeah. What are you talking about? Why me? This is the low-end totem pole guy. This is good. Stoffer for Premier says, I don't know who steals Jagr bobbleheads, but I know who will represent them. EST legal analyst, Eric McRamala.
That does sound like a case.
You got to tweet that story at McRamala.
Yeah,
let's get his legal opinion on
retainer.
That one. All right, Kubet hotline of the day. Sidney Crosby to score a goal tonight against the San Jose Sharks. Can we make it 4-for-4 to start the week? We got a sports update coming up here for Park Mazda. Keyword for Vegas in 14 minutes. On the way next, I got beef. What do you have beef with? Text us. 780-218-9999. What's your beef? 780-218-9999. Sports update with LTE.
Oilers 7-2 over the Capitals to begin a four-game homestand. Zach Hyman had a hat-trick. Connor Brown scoring his first of the season. The homestand continues Saturday night as the Avalanche roll into town. Colorado victorious last night in overtime in Vancouver. They'd rally from 3 down to knock off the Canucks 4-3. Blues topping the Kings 3-1 on the Preds. They have points in 13 straight following a 4-2 win over the Winnipeg Jets. Some news out of the CFL this morning. The Edmonton Elks. They began seeking new ownership in a planned transition from non-profit stewardship into private hands for the first time in the franchise's 75-year history. This courtesy report from TSN's Dave Naylor. The club have been working this offseason with California-based Park Lane, a sports investment bank that managed the sale of the Alouettes just over a year ago, roughly 2 weeks after Park Lane began putting out feelers to potentially interested parties. More than a dozen non-disclosure agreements have already been signed. Raptors falling in Detroit, 113-104 to the Pistons. Six games around the NBA later tonight. Oil Kings with a big 6-1 win down in Lethbridge to cap a four-game trip. The club are back home for a pair Friday against the Hitmen and Sunday against the Broncos. PWHL action saw Minnesota shut out Boston 4-0. That schedule resumes Saturday with a pair of games. An opening round of the Players' Championship beginning this morning from TPC Sawgrass Canadian Taylor Pendrith, part of a handful of Canadians, as he's part of the opening group. Sports update brought to you by the great staff at Park Mazda and dealer principal Mitch Lewicki, where he wonders this morning, what's he going to do with all these Jaromir Jagr bobbleheads?
Hi there. If you're like me, you like to picture yourself in luxury, even though there's absolutely no way you could afford it. And if you can, well, even better. Thankfully, I picture myself in something that is luxury, but still absolutely affordable, like the all-new Mazda CX-90 from Park Mazda. With the new luxury features like facial recognition settings and quilted detail Napa leather seating, I can pretend to be comfortable with all of my proper settings activated without even touching a button, thanks to Mitch Lewicki and the great staff at Park Mazda. I like to picture Mitch Lewicki as a figure skater. He wears, like, a white outfit, and he does interpretive ice dances to My Life's Journey.
Park Mazda, your dealer for life in Sherwood Park off Y Road, Park Mazda.
Connor McDavid.
Let me say yeah.
Remember that name.
McDavid off a turnover. Walks in. Has a step shot. Bluffs it. No, it slips behind Holtby. And that's McDavid's 30th. finds McDavid. The net is empty. Shoots and scores, and this one's over. Connor McDavid. Connor. 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 McDavid. McDavid. McDavid.
Remember that name. Here he is.
Connor McDavid. Connor McDavid.
Smart move. Here he is.
Beautiful.
Remember that name.
No, 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 no. Connor has no limit. No, 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 no. Connor has no limit.
Connor McDavid.
Remember that name.
No, no limits when it comes to this guy. He's simply too fast. Think he can just fly.
In heaven, cause of 9 to 7. The nation in love from Gibbons to Devon. Looking to pass, deep men on the ass. Second contract, a lot of cash. Tick, 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 tack, take your time. McDavid on your team and you'll be fine. Just open your eyes and you will see it. Oiler for real, cause he has no limit.
No, 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 no.
Remember that name indeed. Connor McDavid getting in on the fun is all. We checked off all the boxes on those goal songs. If you missed the Connor Brown goal song, we'll have that for you again coming up here. Maybe at the end of hour number two, if not in hour number three for sure. Sound of the day clearly still to come. We're about 10 minutes away from the keyword for a trip to Vegas with our partners down at Fly YEG. Hey, tell your friends how easy it is to consume Edmonton Sports Talk. When they're like, oh, I don't have time to do this. All I have to do is go to their device and say, hey, blank. Hey, device, play Edmonton Sports Talk. That's it.
Hey, blank.
Yeah. Hey, you. You dirty, filthy bastard. Yeah.
Whatever you call that device. Yeah. Maybe you have a pet name for it or something like that.
Yeah, whatever. Yeah. Do you have a pet name for your phone? I say, where's my phone? But we should start naming our phones.
Well, like, does it address, like, can you change the name of a Siri? Like, can you go in there and be like,
hey, Chris.
I'd like to call you Norbert, you know?
Hey, Norbert, right? Play Edmonton Sports Talk. That'll get there for you. Lots of good Vin Diesel and the Fast and Furious text rolling in on this Yarmer Yager thing.
I like whoever has them. They're all, somebody in NASCAR said they're all in the dash.
Yeah, Strummy said, yeah. I like to imagine somebody driving around with 100 Yager bobbleheads on their dashboard, which is good as well. Somebody else texted in and said, I think Gritty has to be the number one suspect.
Well, yes. Right? Yeah, no, that's
Gritty or the traveling Yagers.
It's got to be from in-state at least.
One of them has something to do with this. I'd like to see that go down. Was the truck moving when they took them, or was this from a warehouse?
And can somebody please ask John Tortorella in a scrum?
What do you think? You think I care about this?
Look, I don't. You guys and your... Ha! He would just explode, eh? Like,
that'd be very good. All right. Let's get into I Got Beef for Acme Meats. Eat fresh. Eat local. Eat Acme. 7 years today in their new location, which is awesome.
Nice that we got the I Got Beef on the 7 year. On the
that worked out really
date.
Well.
Very nice.
I mean, I don't know if they great scheduled plan. That perfectly.
I credit Matthew Iwanek.
Or what? Sure, do you think that's what it was?
Probably some sort of a...
9570 76th Ave. Serving Edmonton for over 100 years. Do you realize how many cattle that is? That they've dished out there in an absolutely delicious fashion. I think that's real nice.
And Corey does a lot of cool stuff with, like, schools. Like, they'll need eyes and stuff and brains
okay.
for, like,
oh,
projects.
Oh, that's a really good idea.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So,
yeah.
Very interesting.
Does he just give them to the schools, or does he go?
I it'd be nice if he'd go and do, like, a little show and tell, maybe.
Yeah, yeah,
kind of
get
to. But I think he just gets into it. Corey the Butcher on Twitter. You can also follow him on Instagram, and it's a great follow for stuff like that. I mean, if you don't know anybody in the game... He's in the game, and you get to see
the
stuff.
All right, what do you got beef with, buddy?
Well, I just wanted to read somebody's beef, and they had a beef with driving through drive-thrus, ordering food, and then proceeding to eat the food in your car in the parking lot. They texted at 6:05 this morning. You hadn't even mentioned anything about I got beef in the show thus far, and they had to get that out right away. I didn't want to forget that text. Can't remember who signed it, but I mean.
Okay, so let's explain that person to us. So you go through the drive-thru, and then you park in the parking lot and eat it. So to me, you don't want to drive distracted by eating. So if that's the case, then why wouldn't you just go in?
Unless you
have a phobia of crowds or something.
And that could be it.
Maybe that's what it is.
I don't know why that would beef you so hard seeing other people do that, though. It would be weird. I mean, it doesn't affect me much.
It would be weird to be behind somebody in the drive-thru, and then they get their meal, they pull out, and they park in the parking lot. You drive by them being like, you son of a. Like, why would that cause beef for you? That's weird to me.
I got beef with the Godfather actually last night, Troy.
Yeah, the Godfather.
He's a bit of a wing snob.
A wing snob at Hudson's last night.
He was calling people. Look, you want to order, you want to order a burger, well done, raw, whatever, you know, wings, bone in, bone out, whatever. But you don't need to be so. I mean, I get he made a comment.
The Godfather eats his wings bone in.
But you know what? He doesn't even eat all the meat off those bones. Maddie and I are watching him. He takes one little bite, peels the skin off, and tosses it in the bucket.
That's kind of how I do it, too. But I would not be a wing snob, because I know I'm not good at wings.
Okay, so that then I wouldn't have as much beef with you. But if you're sitting there and nibbling a little bit of skin off your bone-in wing and then tossing it in the bucket and then crowing at me because I'm eating a plate of chicken and not leaving anything on my plate, I got beef with that. I got chicken with that. And I got beef
with that. Well, he said to me when I got those tendies, and those tendies there are delicious. You might as well just got the boneless wings. And then he looked at me and goes, oh, those tendies actually look pretty good. I said, of course they do. Yeah, they're amazing.
Well, they're like a breast flat.
And there's five of them.
Hugest chicken tender I've ever seen.
It's real nice.
But yes, I've got beef. I've got chicken.
I've got beef. And I don't know. Like, I don't know if I got a notification on this and I just missed it or something. But I hopped on Prime last night, Prime Video, to watch Dumb Money with Seth Rogen. It's a good falling asleep movie. Anyway, I throw it on last night, and there's commercials running on my Prime Video now.
Uh-oh.
When did this happen? Months ago? What is this?
Not Prime enough.
So do you think like my subscription kind of like maybe ran out, and then it just kicked back in, and they're like, but now you have to pay more if you want... But I've watched Prime a number of times in the last like 4 weeks, and this is the first time I'm going to lay down last night, put on Dumb Money, and a commercial pops up, and it was the funny thing, it was the Moose, that stupid auditions commercial with the potato chips. I was like, what the hell is this? What are we doing now? This drives me nuts. I pay years for these subscription services.
What do you
and
get?
The best thing about it is, well, no commercials. Pay the subscription fee. Sure, perfect, done. I'll do it. But I'm not happy right now. I got beef with these online services. Now all of a sudden, just throwing ads in the middle of it. What the hell is this about? I tried to fast forward because I fell asleep yesterday for a nap watching Dumb Money. So I'd already watched like the first 15 minutes. So I was like, well, I'll just fast forward to where I was. Another commercial. Two commercials. So I don't get it. Is this just because they wasted on their money on horrible Thursday night football schedules?
Yes, and now you have to pay.
Is that what this is? Now I'm paying?
This is your fault.
I'm paying because your Thursday night football schedule sucks? We're just getting back to where we were 15 years ago.
Prime
we're just
is
gonna
more
watch,
like...
Yeah.
Well, this might get you the in-season mitt. Hey, maybe that's something you can take this
and
morph it into a take.
I should have. I should have, but that's what I got beef with. Like significant beef with this, significant beef. Cal says, Dusty, the commercial started a few months ago. You have to see what. I swear to God, I've been watching Prime for like the last 2 months.
Swear to God,
and last night was the first night.
You got to pay $2.99 to not have ads now. So there you go. You're gonna have to.
What about my original payment to not have the ads?
Well, that's all changed.
Absolutely pathetic. Anyway, I mean, it's still very convenient to watch these things and all these movies and shows whenever you want. But my goodness, you're really starting to give me a beef here.
Dudley, though, my Prime has had commercials on it for at least a year. So his beef might be, so he's...
Well, how come I... Now
he's
I'm
really
like,
in the mud.
I got a beef. Why wasn't I getting these commercials with everybody else?
Oh, so am now I you not, want the commercials.
Am I not good enough for your ads? Like, what's happening here? Do you think they're confusing pre-rolls? I got in the middle of the movie. Maybe that's what you were confusing. Anyway, either way, it's complete BS. It's supposed to be a commercial-free subscription service. Now we're subscribing and also having to pay for commercials?
What's in a name, hey?
Unbelievable.
T-Mac the rugby guy, I got beef with Section 212, and he's naming names here, that wouldn't join in with the Can't Catch Gretzky chant last night.
Yeah.
Pretty disappointing.
Would have liked
actually
to have seen it.
Beef.
Did you try?
Yeah, I tried. I was in section 215. I heard it like
you were close.
Wanting to be there. Like the wave was almost going.
Did people kind of get in on it? Like,
yeah, not really many. Connor Brown chant was there though. All night.
What was the Connor Brown chant again? Connor Brown.
Yeah, wow.
Awesome.
How did they come up with that one?
I don't know. I don't know how you guys managed to turn Connor into so many syllables and then say Brown after.
I'll add on to T-Mac the rugby guy and kind of Zach too. I got beef with that chant not kind of happening last night. If Winnipeg can do it, as you mentioned the day before, they should be carrying Gretzky's water. Yeah. This should be the place doing it.
Especially like if there's not a Can't Catch Gretzky chant after Skinner robs him three times.
Yeah.
But the bottom line is, Edmonton, I'm sorry, you're not good at chanting. I had to say it. I mean, save my hot takes for later.
Keep them in.
But I'm just so fired up about all these damn Prime commercials that now I'm raging on everything. J-Mac says, hey, was there a Connor Brown goal sign? Of course there was, J-Mac. We'll go give it to you again before 8 o'clock. But we got some stuff to do. I got beef. Send your beef, 780. This one says, hey, guys, I got beef with handsome Tom Cazzola. Not because he complains about the time change, but because he can sleep whenever he wants. The guy doesn't know how lucky he is. Signed, Rudy, father of triplets.
Ugh. Well,
yeah.
Somebody's always got it.
That's a tough one.
A little worse, eh?
That's a tough one. If you got a beef, 780-218-9999. All right. Here we go. Keyword.
Here we go.
I got beef with you if you don't text in this word. That's what I got beef with. Here's what we got for you right now. Keyword. Then we'll go Connor Brown Goldstein. Then we'll talk about this Elks private ownership thing. Like, is that completely needed here? Is that where we're at now? Like,
well, dozens.
Well,
we're dozens.
Dozens of interested parties?
I'm going
to... Is that what the Naylor article said? How does Naylor drop this?
More than a dozen non-disclosure agreements have already been signed.
How does Naylor drop this 2 days after being on our show? Now I'm going to have to text him and be like, hey, can you come on tomorrow? That's a tough spot to be in.
Dave Naylor. Right? He's doing this is to get him back on. It's the Costanza thing.
Dave Naylor. Oh, I guess you should get Naylor back on. Anyway, we'll get to that. We'll get more info on this, too. All right, so we've got, we're teaming up with FlyYG and the LVCVA down in Vegas. And we're giving you a keyword four times per day right here and only here on Edmonton Sports Talk for your chance to win a trip to Vegas. Two nonstop flights, three nights accommodations, tickets for a Cirque show. Presented by FlyYG and the LVCVA. Nonstop flights over 50 destinations. Your sports trip starts with a nonstop flight from FlyYG. Visit FlyYG.com for more. If you win this trip at the end of April, you have to book it in the next 2 months, but you can book it for any time in the next year. So, you know, you got to plan. You got 2 months to plan it, and then you book it, and you got a nice little window. You could go to Vegas next winter if you want.
Well, and the Vegas schedule never really disappoints, right? I mean, you can pretty much go to any day in the year and see something going on of interest. So
the EST Flyaway works around your schedule. That's what we can say. So do a lot of these nonstop flights. All right, the key word today, you just text it in. Don't put it in the nasty chat. It means nothing. You're wasting typing. 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. Today's keyword is sphere. Not S-F.
A shape.
E-A-R. Sphere. S-P-H-E-R-E. It's like
S-F-E.
It's a 3D circle, right?
What was the original spelling yet?
S-F-E-A-R.
Can't say if.
It's just sphere with an S in front of it.
I think you broke my brain there.
Yeah. It's sphere. S-P-H-E-R-E. Text sphere to the inbox right now at 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. And you will go into the mix to possibly be today's qualifier. We'll give you about 5 minutes to get in. Zachtikin will give you a call here around, I don't know, 7:55 today. So you got time to get in. You know, if you're listening, you're like, oh, what about the delay? Don't worry. We give you enough time here. This is not like, oh, get in the next 30 seconds. Text the word sphere, S-P-H-E-R-E, to 780-218-9999. You know, if you want a chance to win a trip to Vegas. Once you get in, it's pretty good odds. It's like less than 1 in 140. So you're going to want to get in on this thing. You can qualify on the Hangout today, Gager and Majot. You can qualify on the Lock Shop with me and Huss. And, of course, you can qualify on Two Guys and a Goalie today as well. The Sphere texts just continue to just come flying in today. And let's talk about the Sphere quickly, because that's something you could do on this Vegas trip. Matt's very proud of this word. He likes it. It's a big week one word.
That's why he put it
when
week
we announced
one. Yeah,
it for
yeah,
some
yeah,
reason.
Yeah.
I said Sphere. Matty's out there sitting on the couch going.
Not bad. Not bad.
That's a good word, Matty. The Sphere scared me a little bit.
Man, that's an experience.
Like
that
we
is
were in the second level of the Sphere, which is a good place to sit, I think, if you want like the full.
But then you climb the thing the next day, and that was the scariest part of it.
I mean, climbing the outside, getting to the top. Physically, you didn't think my body would be capable of it. But when you're in Vegas, you can do extraordinary things. Yeah. I became Spider-Man for an afternoon.
Sure, yeah.
But even climbing the stairs in that top level, I'd like to experience it from the bottom level too, because it can't be near as steep down low. So
I'd like to, I'd like to kind of view things from all different parts of the Sphere. You get in, you take those, kind of like Rogers too. You get that big escalator, right? And you're going up. And
well,
if
we said that when we were on that escalator. Yeah. It was like, this is like the Rogers.
So you're going up, and they have a couple of them, and then they have this hologrammed, what would you call it, some sort of presentation.
A really weird thing.
Real big, and it's, you know, it's got stuff going on. Great explanation, I know. You get to the top, were we level 4 or 5?
We were near the top.
Near the top.
Level four.
So they have a nice kind of concession area. It's very open, like very welcoming. And you don't really realize you're that high up at the time.
It wasn't that busy there that night. Remember, I got that great slice of pizza.
Yeah, so we went for that nature show. You walk in through the hallway, and it's all soundproofed as well. Remember when we got into that hallway?
That hallway blew our
mind. I'm like, am I going to... It kind of makes you feel weird. You get out of the soundproofed hallway, and then you enter the Sphere, and it's kind of like, again, movie theater feel. You get out, and then you look around, and it is like...
We got up to our seats, and we couldn't sit there because we're like, we got to get back out of here.
It's so steep. Yeah. Well, and you're staring at a big screen. You're like, is that... Like, it's a big screen, but it's smaller, obviously, than the Sphere and the whole... Like, it's all the screen, obviously, but then they have a smaller screen. It's like, is that going to be it? That can't be it.
Yeah, that can't be it.
And then the show gets going, and it's boof, but like, it is awesome. It is steep. Like, you are high and steep, and we thought we were going to fall forever.
I just can't wait to see Gary Bettman's huge head at the NHL draft.
Outside,
on the
screen.
On the outside.
They
got to
put it outside, yeah.
That would be amazing. Shaking, so yeah, text the word Sphere to 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. You got about 3 more minutes to get in, then Zach will call our qualifier for today. But I'll never forget it. It's worth checking out. I'm glad I was
with the two of you. That is a moment.
I thought it was easier to take in when we were in the dark. Like when you're sitting there and you can see everything around you, I was like,
that's too much. It's the perception.
Very cool. Very cool time. If you've been there, you know. It's pretty awesome. If you're watching on YouTube, fire us a thumbs up here today as well. We would appreciate that. Give us a sub to the channel. That would be awesome. All right, so give me more on this Elks thing, and then we'll call a qualifier here coming up in a little bit. So Dave Naylor says, what, a dozen interested parties already?
Yes, and I'll just
so a dozen different groups have already signed an NDA.
Well, and they're going through the agency that assisted the Alouettes in their ownership, and that led to a Grey Cup. You know, in the end.
Oh, wow. So maybe this is the first step.
You're looking at paths and everything. But yes, about a half an hour ago, Dave Naylor has a piece up at TSN.ca. Yes, and the Elks, again, seeking new ownership planned from the community ownership, working with California-based Park Lane, a sports investment bank that managed the Alouette sale. And Naylor goes on to add, roughly 2 weeks after Park Lane began putting out feelers, two potential parties, more than a dozen non-disclosure agreements have already been signed. So take that with what you will. While the Elks Board of Directors will be seeking an owner with a strong commitment to the Edmonton community, there's no requirement for it to be based locally. And then he goes, it is believed the timeline for completing a sale, roughly in line with the start of the regular season, mid-April, is the cutoff for expressions of interest. And a short list of finalists will be drafted by mid-May. So mid-April is a cutoff. Mid-May, you're looking at the shortlist, and the hope, he says, is to select the successful bidder by the middle of June.
So we still have time to put our bid in, then?
Still got a little time.
Okay, so, but we have to know we have to beat 12 others.
We got, mid-April, cut off. We'll find out mid-May if it's us.
Yeah. Well, and this has to be, first of all, I don't think anybody's like, no, not private owner. Like, I think everybody's ready for the Elks to be privately owned, don't you? I mean, we're asking you right now, if you're listening or you're watching or whatever, by the way, stay by your phone. If we call you and you don't pick up, you're not getting a callback. We're going to move on to the next one.
And as always, it depends who that owner is. But if you have a lot of this interest, I would feel that it's better than to work through a dozen proposals as opposed to having just one person express interest, like, and say, okay, we got to give it to you. At least I hope they do their due diligence. And if you have a pool of parties interested, you can kind of go through and pick the best one. And hopefully that, too, initiates a spirit of competitiveness within the bidders. But I do like the community side of it because you do have a little control, but I think the people on that board over the years haven't really put themselves in the best standing. So this is what it is today. But I just hope that the new, I'm sure whoever it is, and again, if it's dozens, they'll arrive on the best one.
The this is not just 12 people so far being interested in taking over and purchasing the Elks. Is not just good news for the Elks, that's good news for the Canadian Football
Absolutely.
League. You've got a dozen people interested in one of your franchises.
And as it should be. I mean, the Montreal Alouettes, no offense to them as well, but you have a franchise such as this steeped in history and with quite some longevity with it. So that's a great brand, again. And again, opening it up doesn't have to be necessarily Edmonton-based and locally, you know, through and through. This is to anybody, so.
Do you want an individual owner to have some ties to the organization?
A familiarity with it. I
don't think you want like just some American dude with a ton of money being like, oh, I think that'll be fun.
We've seen other people come into this franchise from outside of it before and do some weird and wild things. A familiarity, I mean, I'd take, but I also do think that there is room for, you know, new ideas and a new vision and a new, you know, but maybe not totally. You want a bit of that and a bit of the other, right?
You would like to see somebody with deep pockets.
Sure.
Who has advisors who are familiar with the team.
Right. Yeah. So a bit of an acknowledgement, I guess.
And the person who should decide who is the winning bid is obviously Dave Jamieson.
Well, he's
Jamo should make that call.
Their magistrate. Yeah, he dons the judge's gear. And
Jonty and Victoria in the National Chat. Ladies and gentlemen, Jonty and Victoria. Connor Brown goal song. I mean, Jonty and Victoria is here. Graced by royalty.
All right.
He says exactly what I was thinking, Dusty. Obviously. Because, I mean, maybe it's not even there. I love the idea of Jonty and Victoria.
It
just lives in my head. We/EST buy the Elks. That'd be great.
Well, you know what? We could throw in a bid. Why not?
Things are going kind of well.
Big deal. Yeah, I mean.
What's that? Maddie would make sure Trey Ford starts. That's in his bid.
Selfishly in this for one reason.
Starts.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I do like that one. We don't have the money, but we do want to start Trey Ford.
Well, and we've got Dave Jamieson, too. I mean,
Well, Jamo would definitely be part of our bid. Jamo's probably part of, like, seven of the bids.
It'd be good to have him on your team.
Jamo's probably on seven of the lists. Yeah. All right, Zacticum, who do we have here, buddy?
We got Robert calling in today.
All right, let's go to Robert, who is our lucky qualifier today for the EST Flyway to Vegas with Fly YEG. Congratulations, Robert.
Hi, thanks very much.
Hey, yeah, no problem. When's the last time you were in Vegas?
For my stag.
For your stag? How long ago was that?
Oh, it's a long time. Probably 18 years.
18 years. Well, congratulations.
Oh, that's old Vegas, eh?
Yeah, would have been Fremont. You would have been on Fremont. So what are you looking forward to going back the most? What's your thing?
Spending a bunch of money.
Yeah. Oh, there we go.
Well, he's not even lying. Honest.
Yeah, the trip will be free, so you can gamble even heavier, which is great.
Exactly.
Who do you bring with you?
Probably my wife.
Bring your wife. I mean, 18 years, unless you're onto a second or third wife, but I'm assuming 18 years.
We don't keep counting.
That's great. That's none of our business. That's none of our business, Robert. Congratulations, man. You are one step closer to winning that trip down to Vegas. Two flights nonstop, three nights accommodations, tickets to a Cirque show. Good luck, man.
Thanks very much.
All right, there you go. Robert, our first qualifier of the day, and I can cross Sphere off the list. Another nice day of words. Back-to-back nice day of words for Maddie.
May I?
You want to see? There's that list of words. Don't tell anybody.
No.
Don't tell anybody.
What are we at here?
Where I've crossed off, you'll see.
Okay.
That's
not
bad, right?
Yeah, I'll take it.
They all fit the bill.
Yep.
They all fit the bill.
No,
so more words
here
coming up on the Hangout today, and you have better chances to qualify on the Hangout, on the Lock Shop, and on Two Guys than you do on the Morning Show. Other people are in work. They're busy with their day. They're with their kids. those are the times. There's a little strategy here. No, there's definitely. I mean, there's a ton of strategy.
You betcha.
Ton of strategy with the
underlying.
The
you haven't even looked at the underlying numbers yet.
No, we haven't dove into those yet. We haven't dove into those just yet. All right, here we go. Here's what we'll do. Coming up after 8 o'clock, Connor Brown goal song. On the way, if you missed it. I says pardon on the way as well. More of your thoughts on the Elks having 12 interested parties in private ownership.
Dave Jameson, who does he hand the rose to?
Which, yeah, yeah. God, that's just, man,
why not?
I wish they could
why
do something
not?
Like that.
Why not?
J-Mo standing there with all 12 candidates, and he has one rose.
The club should have some sort of...
That would be great. I'll broadcast that.
Sure.
Yeah, I think that's a real good idea. If you want to play Kind of Easy Trivia right now, we're just giving stuff away like crazy. Skate sharpenings, qualifying for Vegas. Now we got a gift certificate to Mr. Mike's Steakhouse Casual Up for Grabs. The casualest place ever in the Hampton Inn on the corner of Mark Messier Trail, 137th Ave. If you'd like to play Kind of Easy Trivia today and just keep the good vibes going on the show today, let's do it. 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. I would say if you were familiar with the hockey game at all last night, you should be able to win Kind of Easy Trivia today. Now, it's not one of those things, name another ruler of this court. Name another, because Bob the Goat's record will always be safe with us. But this is an easy one. You're really going to get this today. So if you want to play Kind of Easy Trivia, text Zactacum right now at 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. 99. Just let Zach know that you'd like to play Kind of Easy Trivia today. Get your hands on that gift certificate to Mr. Mike's Steakhouse Casual at 780-218-9999. If you are looking for work, we got a place for you. Not with us. We're not ready to expand like that yet. But Claiborne Services, one of our partners, they are looking for you. They're looking for journeyman bricklayers, apprentices. If you'd like to learn a new trade, they've got you covered over there as well. Or if you just want to make a boatload of money in a short amount of time, Claiborne Services is the place for you. Eric, let's get to a sports update right now.
Yes. Edmonton Oilers with a 7-2 win over the Capitals, kickstarting a four-game homestand. It was Connor Brown scoring his first of the season, as well as Zach Hyman with yet another hat trick, his fourth of the campaign. The homestand continues Saturday night as the Avalanche will roll into town. Colorado winning in overtime last night out in Vancouver, rallying from three down to knock off the Canucks 4-3. Blues topping the Kings 3-1. Jordan Binghamton 40 saves. And the Preds, they now have points in 13 straight following a 4-2 win over the Jets. CFL news this morning, courtesy TSN's Dave Naylor. The Elks have begun seeking new ownership in a planned transition from community-based ownership into private hands. The club have been working this offseason with California-based Park Lane, a sports investment bank that managed the sale of the Alouettes just over a year ago. More than a dozen non-disclosure agreements have already been signed. The timeline for this exercise? Mid-April, the cutoff for expressions of interest. A short list of finalists will be drafted by mid-May. The hope is to select a successful bidder by the middle of June. Raptors have now dropped five straight following a 113-104 loss to the Pistons. Six games are on the NBA later tonight. Back over to hockey, the Oil Kings capping a four-game road trip with a 6-1 win over the Hurricanes. The club are back home for a pair Friday against the Hitmen and Sunday against the Broncos. Minnesota over Boston 4-0 in PWHL action. An opening round of the Players' Championship is underway from TPC Sawgrass. Matt Kuchar, Patrick Cantlay, and Rory McIlroy in a share of the lead, currently at 3-under. Sports update brought to you by Claiborne Services. Take your career to the next level with Claiborne Services. They are hiring all positions, including journeymen, bricklayers, and apprentices of all levels. Take advantage of their outstanding mentorship program and work with peace of mind, knowing they are an industry leader in safety. Visit www.claiborneservices.com or make it easy and give Jeff a call at 780-910-6728.
Hey everyone, I'm Zach Hyman of the Edmonton Oilers.
She's so tenacious.
Hope you guys enjoy it.
Revving up his engine, listen to the crowd just roar. No reason for tension, Zach is gonna shoot and score. Hyman's in the scoring zone. Right into the
playing by McDavid's side. He's got you jumping out of your seat 'cause of that look in his eyes. Hyman's in the scoring zone. He'll take you right into that scoring zone. You know he's gonna score a few. Playing with Connor, it's a top line overload. You'll finally see what he can do. So raise your hands up as high as they can go.
805, Zach Hyman just continues to bury the biscuit after biscuit after biscuit.
Getting a little boring, actually, to be honest with you.
He, like Connor Brown, does not even need to use his stick to score goals. That's how good these guys are. That's how good these guys are. I says Parton coming up, 8:30 today. Three questions too many for Park Mazda still to come. If you missed the Connor Brown off the Schneid song, we'll run that back for you here coming up just after kind of easy trivia before we do three questions too many. We're already over 200 likes today. Let's take it to the next level, man.
Yeah, we're cruising
if
here.
If Connor Brown can score, we can do anything. 300 likes. 300 likes before 9 o'clock. I think that'd be the first time we ever hit that.
Why not?
In show history.
Why not?
Be a part of history today.
I said it's Connor Brown Day.
Man, be a part of history.
If you've always been looking to treat yourself, get the large. Get the cream sauce. You know?
Get an extra cream and sugar.
Yeah. Have something a Peroni. Like have three. Have an oyster.
Wow. Is that something you save for special occasions?
No, it's a Bourdain bit.
Oh. Yeah. I'm not familiar.
He's
I'm
a chef.
I'm sure it's hilarious.
He's a chef.
I'm sure it's hilarious.
Well, no, it's just about, like, you know, today's the day Connor Brown scored. So being it is a Thursday, which some people like to kind of, you know, Thursday you get out a bit, then you sleep it off on the Friday, then Saturday you're back again. It's yeah, the extra, yeah. And Connor Brown's done it for you. Today's the day. Let your hair down
that's
a bit.
That's nice.
You
I
know?
Like that. All right, Zach, who do we have playing Kind of Easy Trivia today, buddy?
We got Garrett calling in, wanting to play Kind All of right. Easy Trivia.
Garrett is going to play Kind of Easy Trivia today, looking to get his hands on that gift certificate from Mr. Mike's Steakhouse Casual. Casualest place ever. 6 o'clocker lager on tap.
Get two.
Oh, my God.
Get two.
Yeah, go in. Take. You yeah. know what?
Grab Connor Brown scored. I'm going to have another one.
Grab the boys for lunch today.
Yeah.
Swing on out. Hit Mr. Mike's. Get everybody around a 6 o'clocker lager.
For Connor Brown.
Have a cheers.
Yep.
For Connor Brown. 137th Ave, Mark Messier Trail. In the Hampton Inn. All right. Sorry, who was it again? I forget.
Garrett.
All right. Garrett. This isn't Garrett Gallipo from Sobey's Liquor,
exactly
is it?
That's what I was thinking.
Garrett, is that you?
No, it is not. I am actually the worm on the Nasty Cat.
Nice. I love it. The
I
worm.
Love the worm. Man.
The worm. All right, here we go. I'll start the ticker after I read the first question, the worm. Good luck, man. Here we go. You ready?
You bet you're ready.
Let's do it. Who scored his first goal as an Oiler last night?
Connor Brown.
Which Oiler had a hat trick last night?
Zach Hyman.
Which Oiler defenseman made his debut with the team?
Stetcher.
How many goals did Ovechkin score last night?
Zero.
Which Oiler owned Ovechkin last night?
Skinner.
I got it. Skinner, the worm.
No. No. God. Shake. Stop it!
They are going to remember that AM radio is a viable and modern source for news and entertainment.
Totally.
People don't listen to AM like they used to. Seems like it's more about FM and color TV.
That's stupid.
It sure is, Kevin.
I'm stoked. You stoked?
I'm stoked.
Just
I'm
so stoked. Stoked.
You cannot come to my house. No, 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 not today.
You cannot come to my house. No, 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 not today.
Great tunes today, man. Great tunes today. This text is in from H.E. Pennypacker. There was a guy sitting behind us at the game last night that would just randomly start singing songs. He was kind of annoying. But then he broke out the Hyman goal song, so then I realized he must be an AM Nasty, and he can't be that bad.
Yeah, the kind of annoying fits as well for an AM Nasty, I think, sometimes for certain people.
Sometimes. Hey, congratulations to the Worm. Worm, well
the
done.
The Worm.
Man. 5 for 5.
And hell of a handle.
Absolutely, absolutely killed it last night. Or this morning. Well done, sir.
He probably killed it last
well
night,
done.
Too.
I mean, probably. Sounds of him. Yeah, he's always having a good time.
He had a lot of good pep in his voice there, eh? Good vibe.
So Connor Brown finally gets off the Schneid, gets a monkey off his back all of those other sayings as well. He did them all last night. Goes to the net, has a puck go in off him. Goal's a goal, baby. And, you know, we've been playing the jaunty off the Schneid song. But as we said right at the beginning of the show a couple of hours ago now, so let's reset it quickly. This might have not happened without the dynamic duo that we have dubbed the married couple.
Yeah.
In town. Yeah. Because we had the off the Schneid song sitting there and we're like, should we play it? Should we play it to get him going? We're like, we can't do it. Jaunty didn't want us to. It just didn't feel right.
But how do we get him going? What do we do? We were kind of sitting there with our hands.
Meanwhile, this married couple came out of nowhere with the, do you want to score a goal, man? And completely got him going.
Browner? Do you want to score a goal, man? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you shoot the puck. You're out of luck. You should practice every day. You used to score like 20, and now you're not. I wish we could find out why. Do you want to score a goal, man? Doesn't need to be a hat trick.
I'm trying.
Tell me why.
So we hit that for about a week. Right, we hit that for about a week.
I think we start calling them Connor Brown's billets.
Maybe that's what it is.
Connor, you're going to live with us now. Like, you know,
maybe that is Connor Brown saying, I'm trying. He really wanted to be a part of it because he lives with these people. The married couple to Connor Brown.
You're going to live with me now. Huh? I'm going to take care of you. Because I love you.
That works out.
I love you, Joe. I love you, son.
That's good. That is that's a catchy tune, though. How many of you have been like, do you want to score a goal, man?
Yeah.
Now, he finally scores. We saved the off the Schneid song for this moment, and we got it today. And Jaunty delivered again. He's batting 1,000.
I think we're going to be glad. I think it's today, yeah. Connor Brown scored last night. He's dragging his sleigh. He's finally off the Schneid. He's finally off the Schneid. Connor Brown's off of the Schneid. It's about fucking time. He's had chances galore, two and ones and breakaways, yeah. But he could never score, even strength or power play. He's finally off the Schneid. He's finally off the Schneid. Connor Brown's off of the Schneid. It's about fucking time. Got to play McDavid live. You should have scored one, you should have scored twice by now. And got to play alongside Dry. How could he not score? How could he not score? How? He's played on every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah. He could never find the twine till he found his last game. He's finally off the Schneid. He's finally off the Schneid. Connor Brown's off of the Schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time.
Oh, Jaunty. Jaunty and Victoria.
Nice job, Dusty.
That's one of my favorite new bits.
It's really good.
Jaunty and Victoria is just me in a Fight Club scenario, and he exists only in my head.
And Jaunty's all in.
Yeah, yeah. Jaunty's like, I'll be that guy.
Of course you are.
I'll be that guy. Jeff is in and says, are Tommy and Dusty still friends after the exchange over Connor Brown on Oil Stream yesterday?
Whoa.
Tommy was a spicy boy yesterday.
Kate.
Tommy came in. He was fired up on Oil Stream yesterday. Yep. And we went back and forth on Connor Brown. I said, I think Connor Brown is better. It, like, I'm trying to think what the exact conversation was. We might have sort of been talking in circles a little bit, but I liked Connor Brown on the third line with Henrique, and he said he would prefer Perry. He didn't like the idea of Connor Brown on the third line. And I said, I think they're putting Connor Brown there just because of the he's got more speed than Perry. And then we got into it with it ended up with, like, if Connor Brown and Corey Perry raced around the rink, who would win? And I
say
think
foot
race
down
Brown.
A Commonwealth. Yeah. They meet in the middle.
Oh, well, that'd be something.
So Tom loves a slow third line.
Yeah, well, that's what I said. Thank you. That's what I said. I said they need more speed on the third line.
That's kind of where I'm.
That's what I said. Anyway.
So, Tom, why do you love a slow third line?
He's finally off of the schneid.
Yeah, take that, Tom.
It was me. I said Tommy up yesterday because I read a positive Jack Campbell tweet to start the old stream.
All right,
that's just not going to happen. So, yeah. All right, 780-218-9999, 780-218-9999. You're having a glorious day, as you should. The Edmonton Oilers walking all over the Washington Capitals last night. Zach Hyman with another hat trick. Draisaitl, 3 points, 4 points. McDavid, 3 points. Bouchard in the mix a little bit as well offensively last night. Power play goes 75% last night. Everything's good in the world. Everything's good in the world right now. And a huge game coming up against Colorado on Saturday. My goodness, that's going to be a big one. Cannot wait for that one. Well, let's get into three questions too many here. Lieutenant Eric, do you have a liner for the segment today?
Three questions too many, brought to you by the great staff at Park Mazda and dealer principal Mitch Lewicki, who was a third party involved in the Detroit Lions extension of head coach Dan Campbell this morning.
Can you give me the other conch? Detroit Lions extending just moments ago their general manager and their head coach. As good things continue to happen to my favorite team for the first time in my life.
As they should. And I just tweeted out a GIF of Dan Campbell going like this.
Yes.
As trending right up.
It's trending
up. It's trending up.
It's trending up.
You got to be feeling really good. I mean, after the season it was. I mean, that was kind of just catching people by surprise. But you are solidified now.
I'm in such
You're solidified.
I'm in such a spicy mood this morning. I'll just say it. They would have beat the Chiefs. There. What do you think about that? I'll just keep this little mitt over here. Scalding hot takes for Claiborne Services coming up around 8:45 today when his honor rolls in, Joaquin Gage. Gage, you're going to be sticking around on the hangout today with Mark Bougeau, one of our all-time favorites, and Matty Wanick.
I love a Gager day around EST.
Oh, it's the best.
Usually Thursdays.
He's
got
on his slippers
on. Yeah, yeah.
Dresses up as the judge.
Raids the fridge.
Hangs out, has a bunch of drinks. Chris Pronger, Journey Whiskey, he's basically only being drank by Gager, and he's taking her down. He's taking her down, so it's good. All right, do you have a Twitter account?
I do. It's @Lieutenant_Eric, where you can find the gift that I was just talking about. I had a few other tweets as well this morning, and the Yermer Yagerhead bobblehead story. I've tweeted out @Macromella. He's liked it, so he's on the case. I guess for that one, I don't know how that's going to turn
out. Yeah, Macromella on retainer.
He's actually driving. He's going to be scouring Pennsylvania countrysides, just looking for overturned boxes of Yager bobbleheads.
But well, where do these show up? Like,
well, that, what? How does this?
Are they never seen again?
I would think that it's one of those. Like, I don't know the story. It's not really specific. Like, was it on a shipping? Like, I'm feeling like it was at sea and it just fell off the side.
Okay, that could have been the case. You know? But I like to imagine them trying to steal something else. And accidentally stealing the Yager bobbleheads. Because who in the world would want 18,000 Yager bobbleheads?
The shipment carrying the bobbleheads has been stolen.
You can't move them.
And I'm just, the shipment carrying, see, we don't, en route to Pittsburgh, but like from where? Were they on the high seas? Were they heading towards the city of Pittsburgh on a high, like how close was it to getting to actually Pittsburgh?
Are they just misplaced?
Me? Did you check under the thing,
Kyle? They get delivered to a Toys R Us or something.
Yeah. Well, Dubas is a busy, like, there's a lot of Dubas, busy man.
This is just Dubas dropping the ball once again. I mean, that's it. I want to see whoever stole them getting, like, perp walk out with, like, the handcuffs behind them and, like, shamed by the entire hockey community.
The reward must be something Yager-esque. Like, you get to hang out with Yager, you know, you play on his line for a game.
That'd be a good idea.
Out in Czechia or whatever.
Yeah, that'd be a good idea.
Kladno.
All right, let's do it. Question number one. Your questions to the inbox, 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. Paddle boats. I bet it was someone trying to steal the actual Declaration of Independence. Right? Nick Cage style. I love it. I want National Treasure 3 so bad.
There's only two, correct? They haven't done the trilogy yet? Okay.
There's only two.
I can't wait for the prequels.
And I think the sequel might be as good as the first one. National Treasure knocked it out of the park twice. It just did. It's the modern day Indiana Jones.
Siskel and Ebert were all over it. It was the modern day.
It's the closest thing we've had.
Yeah, that's true.
All right, question number one. Guys, does this mean that Connor Brown is going to go on a bit of a heater now?
Yes. As has been confirmed numerous times this morning, both Paris Jewelers Blame Box, 780-289-9999, and in the Nasty Chat, somebody said he'll go off for 20. Somebody's saying like a fair 10 from here to the end of the season. I think you kind of arrive on a number maybe around there, but...
Technically...
Dare to dream.
He's already on the heater. Right? Like, he's not going on a heater. He's already on the heater. Gager's here. He's wearing a hockey jersey today.
Let the record show. Well, I had a tweet this morning, Dusty, and I said, Connor Brown pre-deadline, 52 games played, no goals. Connor Brown post-deadline, 3 games played, 1 goal.
It's a little bit of your insider vibe there.
It's a hell of an average, and we said in-house acquisition. Add him to the Corey Perry, and you got yourself a stew there, baby.
Here's a good... I will say, I think I'm going to... He shoots a puck into the net on this homestand.
Okay.
What do you think about that?
You were right yesterday. Keep it going, right? You said the line. Now
he
you're
getting shoots
a
puck into the net on the homestand.
Love it. Empty net?
Because the confidence is out there. Doesn't matter.
Okay.
Doesn't matter. Net's a net. A goal's a goal. Goal's a goal. We're not. Beggars can't be choosers.
That's true.
Right? Yeah. This text in says, maybe they actually forgot to order them because that's what I say to my girlfriend when I forget a gift on her birthday.
Oh, so this is all just a giant cover.
It got lost.
But they've got the Federales involved. Like, you can't really be lying to the.
What a case.
How does this end? Like, hey, that is a, man.
Question number two today. How many goals per year were you guys expecting Hyman to score when he signed here? Like,
on an average, 20, 25 type of thing?
I think if you would have told me he'd be locked in with McDavid all the time, I'd say, oh, well, then he's got to score 30.
97 shooter.
He's got to score 30.
Well, should Hyman be worried now that Brown had his goal? Like, is this...
Nope. No, Hyman doesn't have to be worried about anything.
Well, Brown was the original, right? Like, the original 97 shooter, I think.
Zach Hyman will never have to buy a Panino in this city ever again. Yeah, I would think we probably thought he'd score, like, 27 to 30 goals. And here he is closing in on a 50-goal season. Testy Time says 20. Stoffer for Premier says, I expect in 20 to 22. Dances with Wolf, 30.
Dances with Wolf.
Oh, my Gord, 25. Like, I mean, I guess the message that we're trying to send here and the task at hand is to just point out how far beyond your wildest expectations Zach Hyman has been for the Edmonton Oilers. If Stoff says it, it's got to be true. Friend of EST. And he says Hyman is the best free agent signing in Oilers history.
I'll take it. Not debating.
Kulak's over here like, what? Well, I guess it was a trade. That doesn't count. But I don't see it being debatable. I mean,
it'd be pretty tough.
He's going to score 50. And I think YouTube Trev last night on the postgame show when I was watching said he thinks it's time we start talking about 60. I think 60 is a little bit of a reach. He'd have to be like red hot the rest of the way.
But that could happen. 50's
happening. He
loves him in bunches here, and with Matthews cooling off, who's to say?
Question number three. Guys, whoever ends up buying the Edmonton Elks, what role do you want them to see Dave Jamieson have him in?
Well, I hope it's nothing too busy. I mean, I like my JMO time
as
well.
Yeah, the last thing we want is JMO to be worked.
I don't want
bone.
Him tied up, and I don't think at this stage of his life and his career, he wants to be doing everything and anything. More of like, again, I think, for lack of a better term, an ambassador type of role.
Oh, I want him to be like vice president.
Oh, you want a big title?
Of everything.
Big office.
You know, like you'll have your president who kind of is like that figurehead, but then you got JMO underneath. That makes everything
really
work.
Doing the
right. He's working closely with our boy Dahmer.
The stuff.
He's working with Hernan Salas closely, and I think that's like if EST was to purchase the Edmonton Elks. I saw somebody say, "Hey guys, how much do you think the Elks go for?" And I'm interested to see because how much of it. Look, well, like Gager brought in Timmy City too. He's in a great mood today, is Joaquin Gage.
He's got a kid on too.
No, not really, Gager. No, thanks, man. Oh, did you guys eat my favorites?
Birthday cake.
Oh, are they all birthday cake? Brilliant idea. Brilliant idea, Gager. Did you get a birthday cake too, one?
Very smart.
They're all birthday cake?
They're all birthday cake.
That's amazing.
Well, you're holding Gager's one, Zach. Do you not see it? Like,
well, I didn't check the other ones. I just saw the top one.
Yeah,
and
no, they're all birthday cake.
You can order them all in one.
Oh, they never have the good ones when I ask.
Which is the birthday cake?
That's real nice. Real nice.
They're delicious.
Northside Sandwich says, Jamal will be like what coffee is for the Oilers. Just a connection from the team to the owner. Put him on sideline.
Yep.
Help
sure.
Have him around. Yep.
Force him down on the
sideline. Praise him a lot. And then and be like, well, he's also providing us with excellent information.
Doesn't want to be there.
Yeah.
And I think Dave might be a little, he might like this idea, but bring back the A&W root beer. Have him in, you know,
in costume.
Marching along the sideline. He has some grand memories of the A&W Root Beer Bear.
I feel like that's Hernan Salas's role. I think Hernan's role has been expanded a little bit over there. I'm for sure thinking he's going to be part of a mascot this year.
I'd love to see it.
Yeah.
I'd love to hear
about
it.
And the mascot's in a really good mood until the team starts losing, and then he's just punching kids.
Knowing Hernan's in a...
Yeah. Oh, the Elks are losing. The mascot's fighting a kid. Must be Hernan today.
And you can just hear him within the costume, you know, uttering a few
That's a good one as well. 780-218-9999. 780-218-9999. Thanks to Gager for the Timbits drop-off. Well, Scalding Hot Takes coming up in-season tournament style with YouTube Trev off today. Is he completely off today? Or is he like in later on?
I think he might be in later on.
Is he in later on?
Honestly, I'm not sure.
I like seeing Trev.
He's going to pop in.
Is he going to pop in at some point?
For a visit?
Well, hopefully not. Not on a day off.
Take the day.
Yeah, take the day off. Guys, Gritty has admitted fault to the theft. Is that new? Has that moved? Has Gritty chimed
in?
People know.
Look, if this is a big PR stunt, I don't want to hear about it, actually, to be honest. If this is all just a joke and a gag, they've got the federal authorities involved.
Joke, I'm going to be pissed.
Well, I'm not having it. If Gritty, get the bubbleheads in his eyes are going, they're like, and Cal Dubas is, they can't be doing that. They hate each other, right? That's a rivalry. That's Pennsylvania
they can't do that
rivalry.
Together,
maybe.
Yeah, can't be a joke. No. Nobody says, hey, let's do this. It'll be hilarious.
But if Gritty actually did it and it wasn't a joke, then,
like,
then I'm all for it.
Legitimately stole it. Yeah. Yeah, that'd be pretty good, actually. I do like that.
They got the guy going in. And
yeah. Guys, at what point do we start questioning Dubas' decisions as a GM? Mm-mm. A Hyman miss, a Carlson trade, two big strikes that have greatly affected the Leafs and the Pens. That's in from Grant.
I'm here for the discussion.
Grant, how about you? You nasty little guy. You're firing things up today.
And now he's lost a shipment of Yager bubbleheads, so you can add that to the list as well of GM gaffes under his watch.
Maybe this is maybe Tree Living's a suspect.
A Trey?
Yeah, takes over in Toronto.
Oh.
Wants to screw Dubas over even a little bit more. You left me this blue line? Well, you will not get your Yager bubbleheads.
The perfect revenge.
I think that's pretty good. Hey, if you like this Edmonton Sports Talk hat I'm wearing, hop online. We got some. We got some kicking around at EdmontonSportsTalk.com. If you just go to the website, very easy, right along the top, you'll see it. EdmontonSportsTalk.com, EST Shop. And there's a list of items that we have available in there, all from our great partners over at The Hive, Hive Product Marketing, the official merch partner of Edmonton Sports Talk. Promotional products that bring the buzz. Check them out at thehiveproductmarketing.com. And they look good. They fit well too. We got the straight brim. I think the curved brim ones might be running a little bit low. But if you're looking for that merch, I love walking into like the Hudson's last night, for example, and seeing EST hats just sprinkled all over that place.
It's a good look. And again, that straight brim EST hat is one of the best fitted hats that I've ever worn.
The straight brim.
I don't know what about it.
This one's real nice.
The elastic in the front, like the way the hat is shaped, the whole bit, like it just perfect fit, great fit.
Surveyor Brett, he knows more than I do. He says, curved brims are sold out, Dusty. Of course they are.
Yeah,
I
mean, well, okay.
One of the most
we are not going to agree on the curves straight here, but
yeah, but the hat you're wearing right now, that's a curved hat, isn't it?
Well, this is out of the game. This is Edmonton Sports Talk hat, but from the Edmonton Sports Talk hat.
Did
yeah,
I get you that hat?
No.
Oh.
My wife. Got you Liverpool. My wife did.
Oh, sorry.
Trying to take claim for things your wife does?
Ooh,
sorry, man. I thought I got you a Liverpool hat one time for a present, but
you got me a few Liverpool garb.
Well, I mean, that's like an easy thing for me to shop with you. For you, you're like,
yeah, well, yeah, get all Liverpool the time,
stuff.
Yeah,
you know, loves it. All right, let's get to Isaiah's pardon here. I mean, we definitely could have gone with the Yarmer Yager thing, the bobblehead thing for Isaiah's pardon today, but something popped up a little bit last night. I think anytime you kind of get put in this special company. It's important to mention it. I says pardon. Get a clean slate for an affordable rate, all you scofflaws out there. You got a criminal record right now. You don't have to. Lawyer Central will help you get a clean slate at an affordable rate. Everybody makes stupid mistakes. Stop paying for yours if you still are. You don't have to. Visit www.lawyer-central.com/pardons or call 1-888-288-8177, 1-888-288-8177. And we've been talking about pardons for a couple months, but it's not just pardons. I mean, any sort of legal issues that you have, they can help you out. They got lawyers all across the country. www.lawyer-central.com. This is from Sportsnet Stats last night. And this is just like when you're in the elitist of elite company, you know you're having a nice season. Oilers in history with 15 goals in a span of 10 home games. Wayne Gretzky, Zach Hyman, end of list. I says pardon? Zach Hyman has joined Wayne Gretzky as the only two people to do something in the history of the Edmonton Oilers?
And that end of list guy that you mentioned.
But yeah, I have no idea name, who, what year's end of list
what nationalities.
For, but Wayne Gretzky has been joined by Zach Hyman as the only players in Oilers history, not Yari Curry, not the Moose, not Anderson, not Dougie Waite, not Smitty, not Hemsky, not Horkov. Horkov would be in there, but
Ratty.
Not McDavid, not Dreisaitl, nobody else. Wayne Gretzky and Zach Hyman, the only two players in Oilers history to score 15 goals over a stretch of 10 home games. That is how special the season has been for one Zachary Hyman. Zachary Bartholomew Hyman.
Martin.
In honor of Tommy Gazzola. That's an I says pardon. Like, you know he's having a great season, but when you see, oh, only Wayne Gretzky had done this before, and you've had other Hall of Famers. You got two guys on the team right now who are definitely going to the Hall of Fame. You're sitting there going, wow. And now Zach Hyman has done this.
It's quite a view from up there that not a lot of people have. And as Strummy points out as well, not Liam Reddick's.
Not
you,
Liam
you can
Reddick's.
Add him to the list.
Nobody else. You say any other Oiler in the history of Oilers. And some of the names might end up being very hilarious. But it's only Wayne Gretzky and Zach Hyman. And I says pardon. That's very impressive. Very impressive. Congratulations to Zach Hyman on an absolutely incredible season. I says pardon, brought to you by Lawyer Central. Lawyer-central.com/pardons or call 1-888-288-8177. With all of your legal issues, they can help you out. Lawyers all the way across the country. So what about this game against Colorado here? Eh?
Well, as you say, 2 days now to prepare. Everybody's kind of, you know, you kind of... You can set it up. You can do all these previews.
You're hoping Ekholm's back. You're hoping
sure,
he's healthy.
And I mean, what a sickness, he's right? Back. So it's nothing you
yeah,
think
it's
2 days.
It's an illness.
And 2 days. So. And again, a team that has been extremely healthy throughout the course of the season. Colorado, of course, the back-to-backs. They've been coming from behind, rallying, you know, as you do. And so this is great. This is all you need. Saturday night, it's the late game. It's
the most anticipated game of the regular season.
Yeah.
Until the next time they play Colorado closer to the playoffs.
Sure.
But this is going to go a long way. It's probably going to go a long way for people who out east might actually stay up to watch it. McDavid versus MacKinnon in this race for the Hart Trophy, right?
10 o'clock, a little after 10 Eastern time, puck drop.
I'm very interested to see how they shape up against and match up against the Colorado Avalanche. Colorado, like if you look at these teams, MacKinnon and Rantanen, elite seasons, right on par with McDavid and Draisaitl. Like all four of these guys are top 10 in league scoring. They're all phenomenal players. I'm interested to see how much of a difference maker Cale Makar is in this game, because we know Cale Makar is like this X factor that pretty much no other team in the National Hockey League has and can completely take over a game from the back end and be like Cale Makar can be the best player on the ice in a game that has Nathan MacKinnon and Connor McDavid. And I'm not sure there's another defenseman in the entire National Hockey League right now, nothing against Quinn Hughes, but I don't think there's another defenseman in the league right now when McDavid and MacKinnon are on the ice together and you can still be wowed more by a defenseman. And that's what Cale Makar obviously brings to the table. So cannot wait to see what happens on Saturday night. That's going to be absolutely terrific. Strummy with a late question for three questions too many today. Guys, what would Gretzky's goal song have been in the 80s? Oh, that's a good one. I do think if we were doing shows in the 80s, and mostly because we were also using it last year in 2023, but the Eddie Murphy Party All the Time remix.
That would be great.
As a Wayne Gretzky goal song.
That'd be great.
I got a lot of time for that. I think that's a good idea.
Little West End Girls, Pet Shop Boys, hey, why not?
There's got to be something from the 80s that would have just been killing it. Like
Peter Gabriel's Sledgehammer.
Oh.
Hey, that's
Sledgehammer. That's the one, right? Yeah. That's the only part I know of that song.
Sledgehammer.
Sledgehammer. That's all I know.
Rick James, Super Freak, 81. Hey, that could kind of kicking off the decade. He's a super
Gretzky, freak. Gretzky, he's a super freak. Super freak. Wait, super freak. You just
say the names of the...
Right? Is that it?
It's like, yeah.
But those are the songs, right? Like, I don't. Who knows all the lyrics to Super Freak? Like, come on, man.
Hungry Like the Wolf.
Dalineski says you should make retro goals. We can't. There's just not enough time. I haven't even got the Kane goal song done yet.
When would you play them?
Let alone the Skinner win song or a playoff song. I mean, the playoff song at this point might have to be the high priority.
Well, cup contending song.
Cup run song. Cup run song. Guys, I think it would have been Best Around from Karate Kid for 99, right? That's the 80s.
Yeah.
He's the best.
Yeah, that could be it. That's a strong. I mean, no, you got a lot
to slow Wayne down.
Lot to choose from.
Yeah, yeah. There's some good ones in there.
Shy Boy, Bananarama, 83.
Gretzky loved Cuts Like a Knife by Bryan Adams, I think, if I remember from his autobiography.
How about this? 1982, John Anderson, Wild and Blue. 92. And then you could add In Orange.
Yeah, but that's 92?
82.
82. John Anderson, like the swinging guy?
Yeah.
As before he blew up?
Yeah.
Early John Anderson. Yeah.
You'd have time for an early John Anderson for a Gretzky goal song, hey?
Yeah, I mean, you know that. Yeah.
Ooh, Phil Collins in the Air Tonight, 1981. It's got that build up, you know? You play the whole song.
But there's not enough hype. There's not enough buzz to that one. I'm sorry.
Exactly.
Yeah. I mean, it's a good pump-up song to be playing like 10 minutes before puck drop. But to come in the morning after and be like, Wayne Gretzky scored last night. I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Like, that's not going to work.
I wouldn't mind it, though.
Hold on. That's it? That's the one? Joel says, The Best by Tina Turner.
Yeah.
We don't need to do that today. I know what you're doing there, but
you know what you're
at. I don't think we need to do that one today. Keep these 1980s suggestions rolling in for Wayne Gretzky goal song. And I only know like main parts of 80s songs. That's it. I can't.
The name of the song.
Yeah.
In a sing song, you're like, take on me. Yeah, take on me. Yeah. That one. Yeah. Sledgehammer, I think, was your best work. But,
Sledgehammer.
Whoa, Peter Gabriel in the studio.
Something else.
Yeah, I look forward to Jaunty's next tune involving one of these. Subconscious.
Guys, what about the song that never ends from Lamb Chop's Play Along Show? It's a song that never ends. It goes on and on, my friend.
Some people
started singing it, not knowing what it was, and they'll continue singing it forever just because it is a song that.
The Charlie Horse Hush Puppy and the gang there.
Guys, ITV did one. This makes sense. ITV did one on Gretzky years ago. The song was You Can Do Magic. Don't know who sang it, though. Yeah, was that the one that was You Can Do Magic? Is that it? That's the name of that one?
Yeah, that's how it goes.
Ah, Jerry Carmichael. America. Says, Glory Days. Glory Days. Na, 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 glory days. Yeah, that's a good one.
America does the You Can Do Magic.
Okay. Oh, here's a good one from Wine Guy. Thriller for the Gretzky song.
How's that go?
Thriller. My voice is going, boys. I'm done. I'm not feeling good today. Thriller. Thriller. I think you go like this. You can do that one, too. Yeah. Oh, Jason Fed, dead or alive. You spin me right round, baby, right round. Like a record, baby.
The kid is hot tonight. Lover boy. How does that one go?
The kid is hot tonight. Oh, so hot tonight.
99 Luft balloons.
I remember we were looking at that for the dry set of one.
We were at one point.
Oh, here's a good one. Big Maple Sports Cards. Walking on sunshine. Whoa. There's lots of good suggestions, actually. Oh, this one. Playing with the boys. Playing with the boys. That's a good one, too. Lots of great suggestions. The Doc just became EST karaoke.
Oh, that's something.
And I'm not the one that wins those awards. He's the one that wins those awards.
If I had some change, I'd like to flick it at you right now.
He's the singer.
I'll tell you that.
All right, keep those rolling in.
Can you give me a little Turbo Lover, Judas Priest? Oh. You guys?
Turbo Lover!
That's coming. That you're almost.
I think that's probably it. This one says, Dusty, you know all the words to the song that never ends from Lamb Chop Play Along, but not any of the other songs? Yeah, but that one was so easy. It was just the same thing, and then it was looped.
Because it never ended.
It was a real tricky thing. Yeah, I think that's good. Anyway, I know a lot of songs. I don't want to sit here and brag, but I know a lot of song titles and how they work in the
80s
songs.
Was your wheelhouse.
Yeah.
Damn if you'll get stumped on any of them.
We don't have 300 likes yet. What are we even doing here? Refresh the page. What are we at? We got to be close.
270.
Oh, let's go. Hey. Let's go. We never had 300. Hammer us a thumbs up here. Eric Stewartson says, hey, has anyone mentioned it's Pi Day today? March 14th, 3.14. Yeah, all the nerds out there today.
Absolutely. Well, you know, it's one of those radio day topics, hey, like kind of, what's your favorite pie? Like, I mean, we've gone over this. What, you're not a, it's chocolate pie. I don't subscribe to any others. I don't,
like your favorite pie?
Yeah. We're doing this now.
I don't really like pie.
Yeah, I know, same.
I don't eat a lot of pie.
You don't.
The odd time I'll have apple pie with some ice cream, but I'm mostly there for the ice cream.
And a slice of cheese on top? Are you one of those weirdos?
No, I don't do that. I'm not a nut. You know, the best part of the pie, though, is always the crust. I don't like the filling. I'm not a big filling
guy. Flaky crust.
My favorite thing was, I used to have this all the time as a kid growing up. Boston chocolate cream pie?
Yeah, like a cake?
Boston. Yeah, it's more like a cake. Yeah. But yeah, that's delicious. That, Boston, that's my type of pie. I like that one. Rip City Stat, man. What a play. You're right, Rip City. Lieutenant Eric trying to ruin Dusty's voice before hot takes. How about that?
Wow. How about that, indeed?
Is that what's going on here?
How lewd.
Dusty sings similarly to Jessica Spano when Zach Morris caught her doing pills back at Bayside High.
Somebody thought Gazdic's cat was still on the show.
Look, I'm not a great singer anyway.
But you're playing through it.
But I'm fighting through it here.
Yeah.
I mean,
you're like Taylor Swift on a world tour here.
I'm on antibiotics right now. Maybe that's why I'm a little loopy today.
The antibiotics.
I'm on the antibiotics. Just 3 days. Heavy dose. Apparently it's supposed
supposed
to clear everything up.
Okay, well.
Yeah, I got the quickest doctor in the biz. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I was in the doctor yesterday for like 45 seconds. He prescribed me 3 things. I was like, what? You're either amazing or you don't want to waste any time with me right now. But whatever, I'll take it.
What else are you going to do?
Jason LeDuc says, lemon frigging meringue. That's the best. Never had lemon meringue pie.
Neither have I.
Yeah, it looks creepy to me.
The meringue freaks me
out. What is that? What is meringue?
Well, it's like a soft whipped type of.
Yeah, but where else do you see meringue? Is there another meringue pie or is it only lemon meringue pie?
Just give me some thick cream, you know? I don't need that airy meringue.
What in the world was that Turbo Lover rendition? Well, I was just singing.
Well, it was just a remix. It was a different. You were close.
Singing songs, isn't it? All right, should we get into.
I'm your Turbo Lover.
Are you ready for.
Yeah, let's
go. Scalding hot takes. All right, let's get to Let's get to scalding hot takes. It's time for the oh, there he is. He's ready to roll, everybody. And it's an in-season tournament game with YouTube Trev having the day off. Let's bring in Joaquin Gage, residing over the EST studios here for scalding hot takes, brought to you by Claiborne Services. What's taking us so long? Oh, he's getting his notes, his books, and everything. Zaktikim's going to set that mic up for Gager. Your Honor. I want you to I'm the bailiff. What is this? What is that about? What is this? I'm seeing a potholder in here.
Yes.
We got an update coming your way. What's that, man? Oh, don't you try to ruin hot takes for me. You're trying to ruin hot. Somebody's got to be on a mic and talk while we're setting up these other mics. Somebody has to do it. So we'll, a big Maple Sports Cards in the nasty chest. Let the record show I am standing right now. I like people watching at home. Like, oh, Gager's here. Stand up off their couch or at their desk.
Listening on a bus. Just
all right, let's slide that mic in there, Gager. Gager, I have to say, you're looking terrific today, buddy.
Thank you. Thank you.
What's up with the jersey? Which team was this?
Das ist meine letzte Mannschaft.
Letzte Mannschaft.
Yeah. Das ist wunderbar. Yeah.
You guys have some sponsors?
Ein bisschen. Ja, ein großes Spiel heute mit die Brunekohl Lupin.
Ja,
exactly.
Spiel 7 auf die Schutzspiel. Game 7.
How long did you work on this? What? Like, could you still remember the language that well, or did you like practice a bit?
No, I
really.
That's rudimentary.
Hey, as a goalie, I have to ask you, as a goalie, well, all the ads, was it distracting with so many colors out there when you're watching? I've never asked anybody that.
No, it's pretty sweet though. Like this,
it looks cool. I like it.
You should see when I roll in. If I'm going to the Italian Center, I'll throw this bad boy on, and they'll go, "Oh my God, where's this guy from?"
Yeah, coming through.
Get some free meat.
That's a real nice idea. all right, so tell us about this. What is this?
Well, this is the in-season tournament potholder.
Okay,
God. So we have a.
I like that. So the mitt stays.
Yes.
Okay, but now we get to win this for the first time, which is pretty exciting. Maddie, why are you standing there right now?
He's the bailiff.
Oh, you're the bailiff.
He's going to forcefully lead us
out. Monica's standing next to Eric with like his hands down like in front of him like, together. I'm like, what is he doing
slightly
over there?
Intimidating.
Right now?
Yeah.
All right. So he's the bailiff.
Just in
today.
Case someone tries to attack the judge.
Oh, he asked for this? Like Gager asked for you to be the bailiff? I love it. all right. Okay, let's do this. Lieutenant Eric, you will go second.
Okay.
I guess, well, you technically... He's champ. He's the in-season tournament champ. So should you go first then?
Eric's first.
Eric's first. Okay, yes. I like the hammer being dropped by the judge today. Scalding Hot Takes brought to you by Claiborne Services. If you're looking for work, they are looking for you. They are hiring all levels of apprentices. They're looking for journeyman bricklayers as well. Take your career to the next level with Claiborne Services, hiring all positions, including the journeyman bricklayers and apprentices. Take advantage of their outstanding mentorship program and work with peace of mind, knowing that they're an industry leader in safety as well. That's a real nice bonus. Visit www.claiborneservices.com or make it easy and just give Jeff a call at 780-910-6728. All right, Lieutenant Eric, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Judge, ready to proceed.
Auf geht's.
Here we go.
Time now for scalding hot takes.
Troy Stetcher? More like Troy Stretcher for all the players he laid licks on last night.
Careful, that takes hot.
Matthias Ekholm was holding Connor Brown back.
Hot take alert.
Oilers fans love Ovechkin more than Gretzky.
That's a hot take.
Kate Middleton thinks Connor McDavid needs a ring.
The hottest of takes.
Joe Flacco is German for Indianapolis Colt.
Wow, scalding hot take.
The only way Aaron Rodgers doesn't become vice president is if he has to win an NFC championship game to get the votes.
Careful, that takes hot.
Yeah, Matthias Ekholm was sick. Sick of playing on a blue line with Cody Ceci.
Hot take alert.
Rex Ryan will be watching Connor Brown scoring with his feet on a loop all day.
The hottest of takes.
Connor Brown's goal last night was like losing your virginity to a prostitute.
Wow, scalding hot take.
Tommy's so rattled by daylight savings time, You'd think it wants to be in a committed relationship with him.
Careful. That takes hot.
All right, there we go. Scalding hot takes for Claiborne Services in-season tournament.
Wow, you guys brought it. That's as unglaublich. sehr good Spiel mit Eric.
Yeah,
du bist the I don't know. You're the winner.
Oh, okay. I was like, all right. Congratulations, Lieutenant Eric.
Yes,
in-season tournament champion again.
The pot holder.
Oh, all right. Sorry, bailiff.
Sorry, bailiff. Jeez.
This is Matt. I have to tell you, Maddie's standing there off camera, like this the whole time. They'd be like, "All right,
that's great.
We gotta put a logo on that or something." Sorry, everybody, for this cough.
We'll doctor up that pot holder. Yeah, I know you're playing her.
All right, boy.
That was a spicy. Usually I black out during the segment, but yeah.
Well, I thought when I saw Gager almost pissing his pants in my last take, I thought I had it.
Well, but what was your second last one?
Rex Ryan will be... Yeah, you like that one.
God, that's good.
Rex Ryan will be watching Connor Brown scoring with his feet on a loop all day. Just... that was good. Let's get to some of the reaction. Uchaz says, Dusty by a mile. Spency 5 cents. He says, tough choice. Joel says, LTE. Dusty wins with the hammer. Dusty takes it. Off of the last one, the last take by Lieutenant Eric is pure fire. Dusty hammer win, 50-50 for this one. Yeah, lots of good reaction here. Dusty totally won with the Tommy joke. I thought that was going to take that it.
Well, you had the hammer.
It's been the week of DST issues for Tommy.
And in a tight race, having the hammer.
I know.
You might.
And I looked at his reaction. I was like, oh, I think I got it. Tommy's so rattled by daylight savings time. You'd think it wants to be in a committed relationship with him. Tommy's on a day off today, but I hope he's watching. You know how I love you, buddy. That's just, that had to happen. What was your last take? Give me your two. Like, you had the, what was the one? Matias Ekholm is sick. Sick of playing on a blue line with Cody CC. That was a good one. What was that other one you had? Was that your last one?
No. The last one was Connor Brown's goal last night was losing your virginity due to a prostitute.
Oh, yeah. Jeez Louise.
Well, you know, it's just, it's, you know.
Yeah.
I thought they're loving Ovechkin more than Gretzky. Zach almost passed out over there.
Yeah,
Zach
did.
I couldn't believe I said that.
You heard Zach. He was kind of like, whoa. Lips. Yeah. No, that's good. Jay Siggy Rocker. Dusty with the hammer. Robbed. Dusty got robbed.
Justice for Dusty. Yeah.
Eric wins the virginity to a hooker take. What's hilarious? Oh, good. I like this one. Rob from LA says, Dusty, the Kate Middleton ring take was gold. I was wondering if anybody would get that.
Look, adding in the monarchy.
Maddie probably. Yeah.
Yo, Maddie was all over it, I'm sure.
I thought Maddie
would
really like
You're
that
speaking
one.
To him, for sure.
Right? Kate Middleton thinks Connor McDavid needs a ring because there's a picture of her without a ring. It's caused a bunch of issues. So, yeah. Good one today, though. But now we've got, who will ever unite them, you know? It'd be tough. You'd have to be Scalding Hot Takes champion at the same, or if you win next week, I guess you could put them together.
Think of the pots that this thing is holding. Hell yeah.
Oh, man. Just,
you can always see a few stains on that thing. Like,
yeah, what's that thing smell like? You want it, smell it.
Victory.
Ah, that's what it smells like. Good one. All right, let's get in to the wrap for William Huff. A lot of fun on this show today. A lot of fun on this show.
City Step Dusty just didn't have enough voice left to win.
I know, that's it. Because you robbed me of my voice.
The karaoke.
If I could have delivered... Tommy's so rattled by daylight saving time, you think it wants to be in a committed relationship
See,
with
now
him.
That would have got you.
If I do that, that's a little bit better. Cash says, I was laughing so hard I missed Dusty's last take. Northside Sandwich says, Kate Middleton saga breaks on to the last place I thought it would, EST. Yeah.
Well?
When I put it on, I said, will anybody even get that one?
And Matt, the bailiff, and... I mean, he's all over that story.
Yeah, I figured that one would probably win Maddie over today. All right, let's get in the wrap here for William Huff. If you want your place to look as good as ours, and let's be honest, our place looks damn good. WilliamHuff.com. They've been doing it since 1972, not with us because we didn't start till September. But they've been with us since September, and that's pretty big too. Visit them, WilliamHuff.com. Make your place just look a little bit more professional. Marketing tools, everything. They got you covered over with Bruce and his dream team at William Huff. What'd you learn on the show today, buddy?
Well, we learned that we learned the lyrics, the tune, and everything else going into the Connor Brown off the Schneid song, which was a pleasant surprise.
Yeah, nice.
I didn't want to have any previous knowledge of that tune, so we all kind of bathed in that. But I think the news of the morning and really kind of stole the show. And I'm not talking about the Elks getting over a dozen signatures.
Also, something we learned:
private ownership, which is highly important. We have a bit of a timeline on that as well. Dave Naylor up at TSN has got all that, but it's the Yager bobblehead theft. There's been a grand larceny this morning, and
that is wild.
And they have the feds on the beat. A shipment of Jaromir Jagr bobbleheads that were supposed to be in attendance for tonight's game against the Sharks have been stolen on their way to Pittsburgh. We don't know if that was by rail, by car, by ship, by plane,
I like to imagine it by a helicopter from above.
Maybe a hijacked flight. Like they have one of those cargo planes and somebody took, like, now it's somewhere in Africa. You know?
What was the John Travolta movie?
Swordfish. Remember Swordfish?
Swordfish, yeah.
Swordfish, they take the bus and lift it up on a huge helicopter. That's how I want to see the Jagr bobbleheads get stolen.
Con Air, maybe.
Just like on Swordfish.
Yeah.
I like Swordfish. Oh, it might be like a weird thing, but I didn't mind Swordfish. That was pretty good.
But I hope this isn't a PR. I hope this is actually real. I don't hope it's real for everybody involved, but like it's got to be real, and you got to... How does this all end and wrap up? Do they ever find them?
I hope it comes out like 3 years from now. Jagr bobbleheads located. Dubas's garage. Nobody looked. all right. Let's get to your sound of the day today. Huh, where should we go? Like Hyman had the hat trick.
Drysdale
scored. McDavid scored. It's charged Chinstrap Awareness Month. We could definitely go there as well. This is a tough one.
I think we're gonna be glad. I think it's today, yeah. Connor Brown scored last night. His dragon is slain. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. He's had chances galore, two and ones and breakaways,
yeah.
But he could never score, even strength of power plays,
yeah.
He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. Got to play McDavid line. You should have scored one, you should have scored twice by now. And got to play alongside Dry. How could he not score? How did he not score? How? He's played on every line, but he's best on PK. Yeah. He can never find the twine till he found his last game. He's finally off the schneid. He's finally off the schneid. Connor Brown's off of the schneid. It's about fucking time. It's about fucking time.
I don't know, did y'all do that on purpose?
I haven't noticed.
Edit where it just put the beeps in the wrong spots.
Sure, why not?
Anyway, earmuffs to some of the kids. But there is, yes. I mean, it's censored there. I know Marshall Bo Keith Nielsen not feeling well. He's home from school today. He's laying on the couch watching the show on TV. So get well soon, buddy.
If you're going to hear certain words maybe for the first time, it maybe should be on this show, correct? In a respectful form. You know, it's
talk with daddy.
Exactly, yeah, yeah. That's it. Better learning it there than on the streets.
Yeah, exactly, that's right. All right, text of the day today for A&W. They got another special coming down the pipe next week. And got the heads up yesterday that the Spicy Piri Buddies sticking around.
Stack them.
Till April. So that's nice. So they got those value deals going every single day, though. Budget-friendly options you can enjoy all day, every day, any day of the week. Try an A&W Buddy Burger today for only $2.79. Ridiculous steal. A&W value deals, always tasty, never pricey. Text of the day. Let's go with, oh boy. I don't know, Rick, you tell me. They're both kind of similar, but you tell me which one you think's better. Connor Brown is now only 925 goals away from catching Gretzky. What a time to be alive. That's from Box Pounder. Or, boys, I figure if Brown keeps scoring at this torrid pace, he will surpass Gretzky's all-time goals record in 65,232 games. Move over, Ovi.
I think I like that one.
There's more of a math component to it.
Yeah.
Just taking the goal separation, but actually the days. And I'm sure leap years accounted for as well in there, so I'll go with the
also refers to torrid pace.
Torrid pace. Yeah. I love you, Box Pounder, but it's going to the other.
Yeah, congratulations to Richard.
Richard.
Just Richard in the inbox. Big Rich. He's been hooked up.
There he is.
He's been hooked up.
He also said Sledgehammer would be perfect for Semenko in terms of songs. Yeah.
Sledgehammer. And something's going on.
Yeah.
Sledgehammer.
Yeah.
That's it.
There you go.
That's the one. What are you watching tonight, buddy?
Europa League round of 16 action. We'll be wrapping up later this afternoon. All leg twos of the two. Rangers hosting Benfica, actually, 11:45 this morning. And then Liverpool will be at home. A pretty comfortable tie. They host Sparta Prague 5-1, leading on aggregates. So. One of those games you let the kids play and off to the quarterfinals afterwards, hopefully. Fingers crossed. And then, as you mentioned, busy night in the NHL.
Habs and Bruins tonight. Yep. That one always kind of tickles my fancy. Panthers, Hurricanes tonight. Can the Panthers do it again? Like, the Panthers are just going around crushing contenders.
Yeah.
So we'll see. That's an interesting one on that one as well. And Vegas and Calgary tonight in Calgary, in Cowtown, home of Calgary Stampede. Golden Knights and Flames tonight. All right, that's going to do it for us today. I think we hit a new milestone today. We're over 300 likes today, so that's great.
Good job, Zach.
Tell your friends if you would like to be entertained with some sports talk in the morning.
3:15.
We got you covered right here at Edmonton Sport. Yeah, turns.
Let's get that in on us.
Looks like YouTube Trez been holding us back.
Give us a 3:16, hey? Like, come on, give us a
That'd
Austin.
Be nice.
Yeah. Hell yeah. You know,
oh, hell yeah. 3:16. So like, one more click. And then stop. All right, hangout's coming up. They're having like a pre-hangout out there right now. I'm jealous. Look at this conversation.
Mark Majot,
Joaquin Gage, man. Matthew Iwana coming up. Turn on autoplay on YouTube. It'll take you right on over. They'll have your next chance to qualify for the upcoming trip to Vegas. Congratulations to Robert, who qualified with us today. Three more chances to qualify here on the station today. So we will get into that as we continue to work our way through the day here on Edmonton Sports Talk. For Zach Dickham and Lieutenant Eric, I am Dustin Nielsen. Thank you very much for joining us today. Tell your friends about EST. Have a great day and take it easy.